Dragons Radio Network. Tonight's game.
Joining us here at our TV side, watching us over on Beam 7 this evening is the River Dragons on the road from Danbury Arena, and looking forward to seeing what this River Dragons team is going to bring out there on the ice. Well, also looking forward to seeing what Danbury is going to bring. This is, again, a one versus two matchup in this league, and Columbus has yet to come here to Danbury, but Danbury is also missing a couple of key components to the lineup tonight, which we will talk about in just a little bit. And the River Dragons coming in almost healthy. As a matter of fact, only one guy is out tonight, and that's Edgar Zozulich, who's still serving an 8-game suspension. But for Danbury, as they are 24-4-4 on the year, 71 points, second overall in the league. That leads the Empire Division. Columbus 26-5-1, 76 points. And for the River Dragons, tops in the Continental, as I mentioned, tops in the league. But Jared Yao out tonight, Gordy Bunnell, Johnny Ruiz, a lot of firepower missing. Tobias Ochick out of the lineup as well. And, of course, a lot of hockey mourning the passing of Tobias's father, Gina Ochick, former Vancouver Canuck. It just gone far too soon, and our condolences to the entire Ochick family. But for the River Dragons, getting a bunch of guys back in the lineup, getting healthy, and getting guys off suspension as well. I mentioned it's just Ozolinch who's out, so now perhaps this team really might get a chance to see what they can put together, go on a bit of a run here with a full roster, knowing what that looks like for this team, knowing what they're going to have when the cards are dealt and it comes time to maybe make a playoff run with this team. I'd say maybe, but I think if you're being realistic about it, you know that Columbus is not going to significantly downgrade itself before the end of the season. They are one of the best, if not the best, teams in this FPHL regular season, but they're facing another one of the best here tonight, and it's going to be a great test between these two teams. Let's take a break. When we come back, we'll have more coming your way in just a moment of the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We will have a chat with head coach Jerome Bichard coming up, as well as a look around the league, this Elmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard, and more. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. It's hockey.
Hey sports fans, the seasons are changing and it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Call Air Force Heating and Air today for our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-223-1945. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air.
River Dragons hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
At the Country Inn and Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
At Mr. Sparky, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
Welcome back here on the pregame show brought to you by Air Force Heating and Air. Tom Callahan here with you. Glad to have you along with us as we are getting a little bit closer to puck drop here at Danbury Arena, where, by the way, it is a little chilly up here in the Northeast. Of course, there's an ice storm that ripped through Texas and making its way up through the country, bringing record wind chills with it and the potential for ice. We fortunately have not seen that here in Connecticut, but I suppose you really never know what you're going to get. And, well, as Forrest Gump said, you know, life is, well, Forrest Gump's mother, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. Hopefully the River Dragons get a couple of wins this weekend as they look to take down the Danbury Hat Tricks. So thank you very much for joining us, everyone. This is our one and only trip of the regular season into Danbury. The River Dragons are actually not at home until the 17th, 18th, and 19th. That's two weekends from now. Next weekend, it's a return trip to Carolina to take on the Thunderbirds. And I just want to remind everyone, if you are interested in ordering a jersey, fans, this is your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. Customize your jersey with any name and number and show everyone how much you love the River Dragons. Orders must be placed. Must be placed by February 5th. To guarantee on-time delivery, go to rdragonsmerch.com to place your order today. That's rdragonsmerch.com. And there is no extension on that. There's no move in the deadline. February 5th, hard stop. So if you know you want to get something in, get something in. By the way, in case you haven't checked your calendar, it's February 3rd. You have 2 days. You've been warned. Tom Callahan with you here live from the Harvey Lumber Press Box in Danbury Arena, and looking forward to seeing how tonight's game is going to pan out between the River Dragons and the Hat Tricks. And we already talked a little bit about some of the personnel out of the lineup for Danbury, but for the River Dragons, they started to get some people back. Lane King returned to the lineup. He was out with some bumps and bruises. Michael Greco had a one-game suspension in there as well, but there were some other injuries, as happens this time of year. No matter what you do, you're going to end up with bumps and bruises at this point of the year. The River Dragons are no exception. However, they're as close to a full lineup as they're going to get here this evening. And then Kyle Heitzner is also a new addition, kind of finding his way in the lineup too. And I know that head coach Jerome Bichard was talking about it on the Behind the Bench Coaches Show presented by Mike Costello Law earlier in the week. If you tuned in on the radio side, we were talking about it and how he's looking at it from a standpoint of right now the lines seem to be good, but there can always be some movement. I do know that Storjahan King and Kelly have been amazing while they've been together. That's one I would imagine it would be hard to break up. Some coaches really like to hit the wheel, spin the lines, see what happens, see if something sticks. I don't think that Coach Bichard is really that type of coach. I think he likes to try to get not only a line of three up front going, but maybe even a bit of a group of five, if you will, going along with defensemen kind of sticking with their forward lines. And I believe that that really is something that he favors if he can get those combinations to work, keep those guys together, and he just rolls them out there for power plays that way as well. So that is something that, you know, that familiarity really helps, that connectedness, being able to generate that kind of chemistry doesn't always happen. And you get guys who work well together. Well, even if you do have three left hands or three right hands on one line, you're going to keep those guys together. All right, well, we do want to get to our Zelmo Zip and out-of-town scoreboard here, and why don't we take a break? We'll do that. We will come back here in just a moment. We'll take a look at what's going on around the rest of the FPHL. The NHL is into All-Star Weekend. Tonight is the skills competition over there, and so nothing really to update when it comes to the show, but hey, everybody is dancing tonight in the FPHL. We'll tell you about it when we come back. This is the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show, Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
Hey sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. As the official air conditioning sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, we're excited to be able to offer you our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-813-1935. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air.
Craving a burrito, some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Bar Burritos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom made how you want it on the spot. Bar Burritos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at barburritos.com or through our handy mobile app. Bar Burritos. Food, community, people.
While the River Dragons handle pest on the ice, Orkin takes care of rodents and pest at your home or business. Locally owned and operated, Orkin creates a custom pest plan specifically for you. Orkin can help eliminate and control mice, bed bugs, ants, roaches, stinging insects, and cockroaches, just to name a few. Remember, they're not happy until you're happy, so visit Orkin.com for a free estimate and trust the only pest control service the Dragons trust, Orkin. Now, if they could just control seawolves and thunderbirds...
Welcome back on Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tom Callahan here with you as we are getting ready to go here this evening at Danbury Arena. The Hat Tricks hosting your Columbus River Dragons. Thanks so much for joining us, everybody. Want to give a shout out to not only our flagship station, 106.9 Really Rocks, Columbus's Real Rock Station, but also our affiliates, WZEV 90.5. Classic hits of Lineville, WBRQ 91.9 FM, Blues Time in the City, LaGrange, and WQEE 99.1 FM, home of Southern Sports and Talk in Noonan. Let's take a look at the Zelmo's Zip-In Out-of-Town scoreboard. And what's going around the FPHL this evening, as I mentioned to you earlier. We got a bunch of games going on here this evening, and actually I was incorrect. Two teams are not playing this evening, so 8 of 10 are in action. And in the National Hockey League, as I mentioned earlier, All-Star Weekend, so it is skills competition tonight over in the NHL. But here in the FPHL tonight, we've already got Delaware and Binghamton underway in the first period. They are scoreless so far. The Elmira Mammoth are hosting the Motor City Rockers. That's coming up at the bottom of the hour as well. Then we've got the Watertown Wolves and the Carolina Thunderbirds. That one also bottom of the hour Eastern time, 7:35 on the puck drop. And we are 7:30 on our puck drop here. And so the Zamboni out there following the warm-ups here this evening. And actually, if I'm doing my math right, I think we are on pace for 7:35 puck drop as well. According to the clock here, that doesn't mean that's official time on the countdown, but I suppose you never know. That said, the Columbus River Dragons coming into tonight 26-5-1, and a couple of things they really want to focus on. We'll talk with head coach Jerome Bichard about it a little bit later on, but right now for the River Dragons, this is kind of the dog days of the season. You're just past the halfway point. It's a long trip to come up here. It was 17, 18 hours for Columbus getting in this morning. And the team actually elected not to skate here this morning and then said, well, they're going to grab a meal, grab a nap, come back to the rink. And they got their warm-ups in, and perhaps that will better suit the team as far as game readiness here tonight. Not sure, but we'll find out when they do hit the ice. And when you travel all this way, I know one of the things we hear is always the bus legs, and that term bus legs. Tom, what does that mean? Well, if you've ever sat still in one place for a long period of time, perhaps you traveled on an airplane, maybe a bus or even a car ride, you know you want to get out and stretch every so often. You know, you might pull over, take a little bit of a break, get out of the car, wander around a little bit, get back in and continue on your way. Now imagine that you were that passenger in that car on that plane for, well, 17 hours. Now you can lay flat and sleep, but the vehicle's still in motion. And there's the stopping and starting, and then, you know, you got to stop to refuel at some point and switch drivers and all of that. So that's kind of where it's a different kind of fatigue. And it's not a great quality of sleep either. When you're on a moving vehicle, you can sleep, but because it is moving, your muscles are always firing, trying to keep you in one position while you're sleeping. So in a way, it's kind of like, if I could coin a phrase here, active sleep, it's an active sleep. And it's not as restful as when you're in your own comfortable bed, surrounded by your own blankets and pillows, and able to get the night's rest that you are accustomed to. So out of that, your legs may be a little bit more tired, a little bit feeling like they did something, even though you slept. And that's one of the reasons why. And it affects players' backs, shoulders, necks. You really do have to get loose and be able to try to, you know, maybe get as much rest as you can while still being able to stretch out, limber up, and get ready to go. And just sometimes the adrenaline, even at the start of a game, just isn't enough to overcome the need to really start to get the blood pumping, which is why you try to come out and have a good warm-up and try to overcome anything that even mildly resembles bus legs. But for the River Dragons here, that's exactly what they've got to do, because Danbury is a team that, one, has a lot of firepower, even though they're missing some names tonight, which, again, we'll talk about in just a moment here. But also because for the River Dragons, they've been a team all season long that have not been a team that starts well. They have been a team that doesn't play bad at the beginning of a hockey game, but sometimes they fall behind early. But most of the time, what I've seen and noticed about this team is their level of play just gets better and better as the night wears on. They pick it up. They get better. They slowly improve. And just, by the way, our affiliates along your radio network just redoing some math here internally. It looks like we're going to start at 7:40. Just kind of looking, comparing the clock to what's on the board right now. It looks like it's going to be a 7:40 start here this evening on the puck drop. So just a little bit of a heads up there. But knowing that the River Dragons are a team that gets consistently better as the game goes along, they just seem to improve and warm themselves up, and which is great. You want to finish strong. Absolutely, you want to finish strong. It's why the River Dragons have stats where maybe they're leading or they're tied or even having to come from behind when they're down. You know, it's not the easiest thing to do. But so, for instance, when the River Dragons, the game is tied after one or two periods this year, hasn't happened a lot. Generally, Columbus is leading. But 4-1 when tied after one. 4-0 when tied after two. That's an impressive stat. Really, the only time the River Dragons, by the numbers, are really, really in trouble is when they're trailing after two periods. They're 1-4-1 in the six games where they've been trailing after 40 minutes of play. But again, talk about scoring first. How important is that to be able to get that good start out there? 21-2-0 for Columbus when they get that first goal of the game. So 23 times they have scored first this year. And that is another big time stat. Columbus needs to get out, get the lead. And I think that holds true almost at any level of hockey. You aren't going to win 100% of the games where you score first, but it really does psychologically boost you. It can bring the other team down a little bit. And Look, it's a lot easier to score a second and a third when you have a first. But if you don't get that first goal, maybe it takes you until the second, maybe the third period to finally generate some offense. Confidence is fickle, and a lot of it is mental. You think you're going to score. You think you're going to get opportunities. You're going to generate those opportunities. That is a lot of what the River Dragons have to try to do for themselves, is continue to generate those opportunities. And I think there are a lot of folks out there who would agree with me and say, you know what, it's good to see that Columbus, again, it's great that they get stronger as the game goes along, but you'd really like to see them jump out there and grab that lead and make things happen off the hop. And so that's what Columbus is going to work on and focus on here this evening, is just that first, really, I'll even say 5 minutes. I was going to say 10, but no, really, it's the first 5 minutes of any game can be so important, dictates so much of the pace. And now let's go back to talking about what I was talking about with Danbury a little bit earlier, is the fact that they're missing some key players in the lineup here tonight. And let's start. Jared Yao is out. He's a 22-point guy, but also 90 penalty minutes. And by the way, Danbury, here's a fun stat for you. Those of you who like the rough stuff, 979 minutes in penalties this year for the Danbury Hattricks. That is first in the league by 159 minutes. That is four full games of hockey almost. Just unbelievable to think, or almost three full games of hockey, pardon me, 60, 120, 180. So really it's 10 periods worth, or 8 periods worth, yeah. That's unbelievable to me to think of that. And here's another kicker. So 979 penalty minutes for Danbury, first in the league by 159 minutes. Mississippi is second at 820. No one else has even hit 800 minutes in penalties this year. So that tells you the level of physical play that Danbury likes to get to. So you're missing a guy like Yao, who's 22 points, but also, as I mentioned, 90 minutes in penalties, and that is part of the identity of this Hattricks team. They are not afraid to mix it up. They also are without Gordy Bunnell tonight, 17 points. He's out of the lineup this evening. Johnny Ruiz, 35 points, 22 goals. That is second on this team in goals scored. So Ruiz not playing this evening. You're missing Tobias Ogic. And with him out of the lineup, that's another guy who, he's only played 3 games for this team but had 6 points. He is a high-flying offensive player and a guy who can put the puck in the net. And someone that they're going to miss not having in the lineup here this evening. So to get back to talking a little bit earlier about jumping on a team early, especially when they're missing their stars, especially when they're missing players who can make an impact, that is exactly what the River Dragons need to do here. They need to try to get on those guys early to see if they can get them to make an impact, to see if they can push them back. And maybe Danbury looks down the bench a little bit, and that puts more pressure on a guy like Dustin Gesso, who is the leading scorer on this team this year. He's got 24 goals, 42 points on the year, but it makes him have to pick up a lot of slack, and it puts the pressure on him to do so. And Dmitry Kuznetsov, 16 goals. He's third on the team this year. It makes a guy like Kuznetsov have to really pick up his game. And that's really the luxury of scoring up and down the lineup does not rest with every team. Now, Danbury is deeper than most. 5 players in double digits this year. McKittrick and Michael Marchessault also double digits in goals. But you look, so for instance, the River Dragons, who have the league's right now leading goal scorer in Jacob Kelly, he's got 28 to lead the team in goals this year. But Alex Storjahan's already hit the 20-goal plateau. Then Cody Wickline, I was actually a little surprised looking at Cody Wickline's stats today. 14 goals, 39 points for Wickline this season. He is actually having a very, very good start to the season. And so I have to give credit where credit is due with Wickline, and almost sneaky, kind of quiet the way he's been going about it this year. But Austin Doe is over 10 goals now. Thomas Allworth, he's got 11. Jay Krupp's got 11. So the depth of the scoring is there. And you look at Allworth has missed some time this year. You know, his numbers could be higher. So the depth is there for the River Dragons. There's also depth for the Hattricks. It's going to come down to which team can spread the scoring out a little bit more here on the weekend. Two excellent goaltenders going head-to-head. Brian Wilson is the league's wins leader. Meanwhile, Brendan Colgan, tonight's starter, leads the league in all the other goaltending categories this year. Goals against, save percentage, shutouts, and is not that far off Wilson's win total either. So it should be a very good matchup between these two teams this season. Why don't we take a break here, and when we come back, we'll have our chat with River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard. Then on the other side of that, we're going to drop the puck and play a little bit of hockey here at Danbury Arena. The Hat Tricks hosting your Columbus River Dragons. Stay tuned. There's plenty more coming your way in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Complete Tire and Service, located at 3109 Victory Drive in Columbus, is the perfect place to take care of everything your vehicle needs. From preventive maintenance to alignments, brakes, oil changes, and more, your friends at Complete Tire and Service have you covered. Need tires? Buy three, get one free for passenger vehicles. Call 706-321-8133 to set up your appointment. 321-8133. Complete Tire and Service on the web at ctstires.com.
HydroLife Therapy in Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, HydroLife treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the Ivy League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at HydroLifeTherapy.com/Columbus. HydroLife Therapy. Start living your best life.
Hey, sports fans, the seasons are changing and it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Call Air Force Heating and Air today for our special $69 tune-up offer. With an Air Force tune-up, a certified and trained technician will perform a comprehensive inspection and duct inspection. This can help reduce utility costs and prevent costly repairs. Schedule your tune-up today. Call 706-223-1945. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating in air.
You know that sound anywhere. It's the crisp crunch of that first nacho chip. With its perfect cheese to sour cream ratio sitting atop a layer of delicious beans, it's a sip away from perfection. That's what we're looking for. Add a delicious, refreshing Pepsi and we've achieved absolute nacho nirvana. Because while you can pile those nachos high with every spicy, cheesy, savory topping, there's no topping a cool Pepsi finish. Nachos, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Welcome back here in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We're joined by head coach Jerome Bichard. Coach, in Danbury this week to take on the Hat Tricks. And we talked about it on the radio show and the TV show earlier this week, but these guys are a little bit different team at home than they are on the road.
Yeah, you know what? They got a couple guys that are here, Giselle being one of them. I think last time we played him, I think McDonald was out and called up. So I think they've made a couple changes. And I think at the same time we're missing Aldworth and maybe one or two guys as well. So I think we should have both just about both full teams, and it should be a really competitive game.
You know, outside of starting the season and maybe even then, sometimes it's rare that both teams do have their full lineups.
Yeah, you know what I mean. 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, we were kind of in a little bit of a conundrum there with some injuries and all that stuff. So good to have everyone back, and suspensions are just about over. Still got Ozo that we're dealing with, but no, we're up here. It's cold in here. It's old time hockey, I guess, when it comes down to it. And you know what? We just gotta make sure that we're ready to go right off the hop.
Well, I guess the best way to keep warm is to keep the legs moving, right?
That's right. First keys of the game, Tom. Here we go. I'll beat you to the punchline. You know what? We got to dump and chase first 10 minutes over the red line. Dump it in. Get our feet going. Get our legs, get our forecheck, get into the game, and then we can kind of ease off, hopefully start carrying the puck in a little bit more and all that stuff. So they like the block shots. We need to shoot the puck from all over the ice, shoot before they close the lanes and block shots.
What else is it this Danbury team does well? They're the second best team in the league this year. What's contributing?
You know, I think they got guys that put the puck in that at the right time. Their goaltending is strong. I think their defense is strong too. So, I mean, it's a good test for both teams. And you know, I think we play similar hockey where we're going to dump and we're going to chase and we're going to possess the puck when we possibly can and crash the net. So hopefully we outscore them and outplay them, win the battles on the board.
Well, I guess we've already covered it pretty well, but I got to ask, keys to the game, anything else you want to add?
You know what? Dump and chase. We need to be hit physical. We need to beat them at their own game, and hopefully we can come away with 3 points.
Coach, thanks. Good luck tonight.
You bet.
Back with the drop of the puck in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
So you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 815th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
It's time for River Dragons Hockey. Tonight's game is brought to you by Sun South, Hydra Live, Mr. Sparky, Express Printing, BioLife Plasma, Pepsi, Vector Ply, Zelmo's Zip-In, Houston Clinic, Columbus Diagnostic, Kinetic Credit Union, IGH Properties, Trivoli's, Shredaway, Nuke's Eatery, West Georgia Oral and Facial Surgery, Victory Land, Wade Cleaners, and BMB Broadcasting. Now let's start the game with the voice of River Dragons Hockey, Tom Callahan.
And welcome back here to Danbury, Connecticut. Danbury Arena, site of tonight's game between the River Dragons and the Hat Tricks. We are awaiting the Hat Tricks to take the ice here yet. We're waiting for the starting lineups and our national anthem, but that does give me a chance to tell you, River Dragons fans, this is your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. Customize your jersey with any name and number to show everyone how much you love the River Dragons. Orders must be placed by February 5th to guarantee on-time delivery. Go to rdragonsmerch.com to place your order today. Also, would like to remind everybody, hey, don't forget to tune in to the River Dragons Radio Coaches Show, presented by Mike Hostel Law, every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. right here on Flagship Station 106.9. Really rocks, Columbus's real rock station, and our radio network. Coach Bichard joined by a different River Dragons player every week. This past week, Christian Pavlos was on the show. Great show. A lot of fun talking to Christian, getting to know him a little bit, the newest River Dragons netminder. Also, the Columbus River Dragons TV Coaches Show airs every Thursday night at 7 p.m. on CTM Channel 16, replaying at 11 a.m. on Saturday mornings. Don't miss it. And so it looks like we are going to get ready to go here in just a little bit. And that was our Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Tom Callahan with you here, broadcasting live from the Harvey Lumber Press Box. And now we are going to send it on down to the ice, I believe, for tonight's national anthem. Indeed we are. So down to the ice we go.
We'll start off this evening with the playing of the Canadian national anthem. Thank you.
gentlemen, please welcome the Brewster High School Chorus.
And there we go, tonight's national anthem in the books as we are getting ready to go here from Danbury Arena. They'll bring the lights back up, and then this crowd will try to urge its hometown hat tricks on to victory. However, I do have to say, there are some Columbus River Dragons jerseys here in the crowd, and that is impressive. Matter of fact, down to our right, we have occupying their own row, we got some River Dragons fans who are actually very well dressed for this. They've got their toques on, their blankets. It's cold in this arena. Don't kid yourself. It's 8 degrees outside. 8 degrees here in Danbury. 8 whole degrees. But you know what? I can't complain because there's no snow right now. But this is a pretty chilly arena. And to that end, and you heard me kind of jokingly reference it, but really not with head coach Jerome Bisharb. What's the way to keep yourself warm, keep yourself moving? Skating. Getting out there, playing hard, moving the legs, doing what you can is going to be very important for this River Dragons hockey team. And, of course, the hat tricks are going to want to do the same thing, but I'm looking at it from a River Dragons standpoint saying they're not necessarily used to playing in a place that is so cold on a consistent basis. Sitting on the bench could be a painful experience. It's not something you really want to do, especially if you're maybe that 10th forward for the River Dragons. Certainly not if you're a backup goaltender. Christian Pavlos, I wouldn't blame him if he snuck a hot water bottle in there with him, trying to keep himself from feeling too frigid here. But you know what? It's going to be an interesting go here. And again, Danbury, very good at home. A tough team overall. And this is their fans. They're going to want to come out and put on a show. So let's see what happens. About ready to get it underway. And here we go. Danbury wins the faceoff to start things off here. And the hat trick's trying to go up the left side, picked up by Storjahan. And now quickly, LaBelle the other way. Right wing side pass for King. He'll leave it back off to Greco. Greco, open wing, left side, Kelly ahead. Storjahan tipping it on, tried to deflect it through to himself. Instead, that's played away from him by Borshev under the far side. Puck up the wall, not out. And now it's cleared away. Bouncer at center. Storjahan will get it over to LaBelle. LaBelle quickly to center. If it looks like neutral ice is a little bit smaller here, it is. It's a little bit faster rink to play in. You move quickly through that neutral ice area, and so the transition game for both of these teams is going to be extremely important here. Greco, not in a hurry as his mates change up front. That is complete now. He'll go right side to Rogers. Rogers will skate it ahead, dump it, looking for Doe on the right side. Jemayev can't catch up with it. Played off the high glass, bouncer to the line, not out. Kept in by Heitzner. Danbury on it. They'll try to backhand it away out to center. Here they come. Dumped in wide of Colgan. Puck dies in the corner. That allows Petrantonio to bank it out. Chased down by Gonzalez. He has to loop back into his own end. And the puck ends up scooted all the way down. Well, Colgan, just, he's so casual about everything. He's so cool. He played it ahead. It looked like he was going to freeze it. Here's Jemayev, him with a shot. He ripped that one wide to the blocker side of Wilson. Petrantonio trying to keep it at the left point. Does. Here's Dope. High slot feed for Heitzner. Went into his body. Heitzner ends up sending it out of play as he tried to keep it in the corner. They say deflected. And, well, nope. Faceoff will come outside. 1:44 into this first period. Scoreless draw here. We get a little rushed to get things going. It's an uncomfortable 8 degrees here in Danbury, Connecticut. If the temperature in your home isn't comfortable, call Air Force Heating and Air. Here come the River Dragons. Back up the left wing side, led by Aldworth. Aldworth into the corner, near side. Support from Wickline. Plays it back up towards the left point. Frazio stepping down, able to keep it in at the line. On the far side, McDonald. Able to get it to the line. Nope, not out. Krupp, nice job to keep that one in. Now Dowler. Chased behind the net. Pestered by Aldworth. Puck turned over to Wickline. Aldworth side of the net. Trying to scoop it in front. Blocked by Wilson Stick. Right point. Vanelli drive. That one also hit traffic in front. Wickline into the right side with it. He'll cycle it to Krupp. Krupp spins it around behind the net. Down for the left point. Frazio up. And he scoops it out of play. That'll get us another whistle here. 2:36 into the first period. That was the first shot of the game for either side there. Wilson making the save. Both teams will change up the lines here. Storjahan, King, and Kelly back out there with LaBelle and Greco. Draw one back. King will help it over to Greco on the right side. He'll put it in, but not very deep. And that allows Gonzalez to turn it up at center where it is picked off by King. He'll feed the D. Right side here, Storjahan. Pass up the middle for Kelly. Too far. Danbury on the regroup. And the hat tricks. Gonzalez feeding it back. Now backhand dump far side. Greco picked it off. Trying to help King get it out of the zone. It does get over the line. Push back in. Danbury is offside. And if you need a little off your sides, call Old School Barbershop online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. Book online 24/7, not only on the website, but also through their Instagram and Facebook. Faceoff is controlled by the Hatricks, but a bouncing puck foils the dump in. Now they get it in, but not too deep. LaBelle ends up with it left side, tipped along by Kelly. His redirect down, they see no icing, and as it deflected off Robertson. McDonald out the far side of his net with it. Skates around one, now feeds it up. Two on two developing here. There's a chance on the backhand, but a nice job by LaBelle tying up the stick there and taking it away. Puck stays in the near side. And now it's cleared right into the River Dragons bench. And now we get the first chirping between said benches. Storjahan having words with a couple of the Danbury players. Faceoff will be to the left of Colgan. Kept into the point, shot in. Colgan save, rebound pushed wide. Underwood left it behind the net, but turned it over. Danbury keeping at the left point. Dowler, his shot. Left pad save, Colgan. Now at the right point, long shot. That is floated wide by Pamaleon. Puck ends up behind the net. Colgan out to play it. Leaves it around to Jemayev. Jemayev backhand up through center. Couldn't quite get it through to Heitzner. Dumped right back in. Rogers after it into the River Dragon zone. Watched by Kuznetsov. Ramps it around right side. Here's Jemayev putting it into the slot looking for help. But Heitzner couldn't get there in time. And now back, here's a lead into the skates, though, of DeBenedet, and he couldn't do anything with it. Turned right back the other way. Gonzalez, right side. Gesso dumping it in. First time we've heard his name here in this one. 24 goals on the year for Gesso. He did not make the trip last time down to Columbus, so River Dragons fans didn't get a chance to see him in action. Puck in front, save made by Colgan at the left point, held in by Riley Robertson. River Dragons away. Left side, Doe moving it ahead. Aldworth cutting into the left wing corner. Aldworth moving it around, looking for help. Doe, Wickline on the cycle. Wickline near side, down low for Doe. Doe out the right wing. Doe to the right point. Shot coming in by Greco, steered aside by Wilson. Hot rebound off the glass, ends up with a far dot. Austin Doe on it there, fed it between the D, out it goes. Coming up on 5.5 minutes gone here in this first period, presented by SunSouth John Deere. No score between the River Dragons and the Danbury Hat Tricks. Shots are 3-0 in favor of Columbus. Although that doesn't seem right. They got to catch up with that on the board because certainly Danbury's had some shots. Left side moving in. Here's a chance on goal. Teed up, save. Colgan rebound sitting in front. Colgan paddles that one away. It ends up in behind the net. Now chased after. And ripped up the right side wall, but stopped at the right point. A shot off a shin pad in front. Another chance. Oh, that one just whistled wide of that far post. And now the River Dragons just trying to move the puck out. There's a chance in. Wilson with a blocker save. And the puck sent back down. No icing as Colgan out to play it. He'll leave it for LaBelle. Your storage a hand up the left wing, feeding it back across, tipped in onto the right wing corner, Underwood. Played back around. And that one, well, I thought it hit somebody to the River Dragons bench. I guess not. No icing, LaBelle after it. Played up the near side. Heitzner tipping it along, Greco into the rush. Feeding for Jemayev, a little too hot to handle. It chases it down into the corner. And now that one, Underwood tried to scoop it in front. It ends up behind the net. Jemayev after it, knocked down back there. Underwood on it. Underwood on the near side. Feeding left point, Rogers long shot. That one off a foot on a block there. Painful block for Robertson. Now the other way, here's a chance. Breaking ahead. Defended at him with a shot. Save. Colgan and the rebound is scooped out of harm's way. Big stop in the early going from Colgan. Now it turned over again and a little too far on the stretch of the breakaway. DeBenedet was slow coming out of the zone. And boy, oh boy, he's at the end of a shift anyway. But that could have been another dangerous chance had the pass been a little bit closer to home. Gonzalez out the left side of the net with it. He'll look to move it ahead. Now onto the right wing. That's chased by Luke Richards into the corner. Sends it in front. Sticked away by Colgan. McKittrick to the left point, sent right back down low. McKittrick will try out the near side. He'll feed the right point this time. Gonzalez with a wrister in. Save made. Colgan in front. A rebound chance. Didn't get through. And now here come the River Dragons. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Leading it ahead is Krupp. Krupp weaving in the line, but that puts the play offside. This offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop. Online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. 8:06 gone in the first, scoreless. We'll be right back with more Columbus River Dragons Hockey. River Dragons Hockey.
Face it, you've been borrowing your buddy's tractor long enough. It's time to get your own John Deere from SunSouth. And SunSouth makes owning a John Deere easy and affordable with financing as low as 0% interest. Right now, you can drive off in a 1-series tractor with loader starting around $200 a month. But watch out, when you have a John Deere, your friends may start appearing out of nowhere. For quality John Deere equipment, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that do.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires January 31, 2023.
River Dragons Hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like Chuck-a-Pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
And we are back here at Danbury Arena. Tom Callahan here with you as the River Dragons and the Hat Tricks scoreless and early going here. And now it is Columbus trying to clear its own zone. Kept it on the left side. McKittrick. Now he lost it out to center and actually all the way back to the Hat Tricks end of things, it goes. Tossed in and stopped behind the net by Wilson. over the far corner. Gibbs up the wall, but turned right back. That one wide on the blocker side. Kept in left point by Frazier. Frazier with a shot. That one missed the cage as well. Krupp on the right side. Feeding it behind for Aldworth. Aldworth backhand pass hit the back of the net. Ends up on that far side wall. Boy, the River Dragons having a heck of a time right now. Trying to generate some offense. Back come the hat tricks. That shot in is handled by Colgan. Rebound in front. Falanga overskates. And now it'll be pushed ahead. Columbus stretch pass. Looking for Kelly. In behind the D, but it rolled away from him into the corner. He tried to center. Put it off the back of the net. Storage a hand knocked down. Can't come up with the puck. King bumping his man. Puck comes to Wilson, and he will flop the mitt and cover. Wilson electing to hold on. So Danbury has come out to a hot start here in the first period, but Brendan Colgan has been equal to the task. Eight saves already for Colgan. And this is kind of the River Dragons needing to get the legs going a little bit here. They get through almost his first 10 minutes and maybe then settle in. Puck at center, picked up Kelly. Left side feeds Greco. Greco long shot handled by Wilson. And a hold on. Face off will be to his right. Jemayev, Doe, Underwood up front. LaBelle and Greco remain on the points here. Danbury wins the draw, however. And the hat trick's away. Up the right side. Long shot floated wide of the net. Around to the far side it goes. And Underwood, pressure on the far wing. Can't take it out of the zone, however. Back on the left side, here's Doe. Doe, a centering feed. That one is denied. Picked up by Kuznetsov. He'll feed it ahead, chasing it down into the corner, and now we get a whistle for icing. That was Gesso who was chasing it down and complaining, and well, probably rightly so, that one should have been icing, but they whistle it down. 9:49 to go in the first. Scoreless. Back with more River Dragons hockey.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Face it, you've been borrowing your buddy's tractor long enough. It's time to get your own John Deere from SunSouth. And SunSouth makes owning a John Deere easy and affordable with financing as low as 0% interest. Right now, you can drive off in a 1 Series tractor with loader starting around $200 a month. But watch out, when you have a John Deere, your friends may start appearing out of nowhere. For quality John Deere equipment, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that do.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires
January 31, 2023. Welcome back to Danbury Arena. Tom Callahan here with you. Thanks for joining me, River Dragons fans. They decided to drop the puck at center ice after the errant icing call. Doesn't really help Danbury's case to keep the action going. Actually, a nice break for the River Dragons. Although right now the River Dragons being outshot 8-3 in the early going here. And would like to find the keys to the car, turn the engine over, and get it going. Kept into the point. No, it was not. Offside whistle as Petrantonio brought it back in. That offside brought to you by Old School Barber Shop. Online at Old School Barber, SHOPPE.com. If your sides are a little off, check out Old School Barber Shop. Book online anytime. Also, book online 24/7 through their Instagram and Facebook. Aldworth out there with Krupp and Wickline. Draw one back. Petrantonio on it. Feed it to Rogers on the right side. He'll throw a long one in wide of Wilson. Left side is Jemayev on it. Feeding it behind the net. Hook back up on the left side. Pardon me, that's Krupp. 22, not 12. fed to the point, but Rogers unable to get to it in time to keep it in. And it's tapped further down the ice. Petrantonio after it, banks it off the dasher away to center. Coming up on nine remaining here in this first period. Scoreless between Danbury and Columbus, first of two. Between these two squads, they're back at it again tomorrow. Icing against Danbury. That one's legit. This first period of play brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. Faceoff will be back down to the right of that hat trick's net. They've got the orange jerseys on tonight. River Dragons to the road. White storage hand to Kelly on the draw. Left point Frazio back down the wall. Here's King. Slot. Kelly's shot. He had his stick tipped. And the puck ends up in the far corner. Attempted to dump in from center there. Puts the play offside. Marchessault fed it into the defender, then got it right back at his own shin pads. But the play had gone offside by that point. Brought to you by Old School Barbershop. Need a little off your sides? I know a place. Old School Barbershop. SHOPPE.com. Face off controlled by the River Dragons. And there's a lead. Oh, nice job. Kelly takes the pass. Tried to toe drag in. Poked away. Frazio into the slot. Storjahan roller in on goal. Poked away by Wilson. Storjahan steals it back on the right side. King. Kelly. Bouncing puck. Couldn't walk it in front. And now back the other way. Belenga trying to dump that one in. Picked off by Frazio, and he will just use the glass, but can't get it out. Belenga keeping it in. Left side feeds over to the dot. Backdoor chance, and that one was heeled into the corner there. Igor Borshev, all by himself, had all day to shoot. And he just couldn't get it on net. Almost missed the puck entirely. River Dragons finally move it away. Here's King up the right side. Takes a bump, but gets it deep. Back the other way, Danbury at center. They'll fire one, and that goes off the mid of Greco. LaBelle stepping over to help out. LaBelle, slow it down behind the net. Heinzner ends up with it on the left wing. Back to the right side to Greco. Tried to dump it cross corner, hit a skate, kicked right back out to center. Greco bumped his man off the puck, sent right back in by LaBelle. Heinzner on the left side. After it behind the net. Fed away from him. Pamaleon getting it out to center, but turned over to the River Dragons. Now Columbus is starting to wake up a little bit here. Heitzner back in on the left side. Feeds it out to the right wing. A shot! Blockered up in the air by Wilson. Rebound ends up with Heitzner again. His wrister tipped on the way through. Ends up in the gear of Wilson. Looked like that one actually went off the body of Underwood on the way in there and proved to be much more of a challenging save. Well, fans, if you didn't hear me talking about it in the pregame, this is your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. Customize your jersey with any name and number and show everyone how much you love the River Dragons. Orders must be placed by February 5th, which is Sunday, to guarantee on-time delivery. Go to rdragonsmerch.com. Danbury back in. Yeah, the River Dragons right back out with it. Up the left side, here's Aldworth cutting in over the line. High slot, Aldworth chasing it to the far side. Sweeps it around behind the net, wick line. Couldn't perform the stick lift there. Dowler took it away, got it to the line, and it is kept in onside. Dowler challenging Aldworth, knocks him down. And Dowler feeds it behind the net. Gibbs over after it, right back up that far side wall. Puck turned over at the line, Aldworth. Fed it right back onto the stick of Marchessault. He gets it out to center. Now Petrantonio hustling down after a roller. They'll move it back to Rogers. Rogers circling in his own end. Through center now. They'll fire one in over top of Wilson. Picked up by Robertson. His lead on the left wing side. Back in come Danbury. Vanelli. Be able to knock that puck off the stick of Falenga. Robertson holding it in down for the right point. Around it goes to the left wing half wall. Stays in. Pushed in front. Bouncing puck. Lugo can't get a shot off. Danbury controlling, however. Falenga looping along the blue line to his left. Feeding it to the dot. Pass is tipped away, and now here's King. With a hard pass. Puck hopped on him, and he hooked it way behind Kelly. Danbury. Trying to say too many men against the River Dragons as they were executing a change there, but nothing comes of that. Gesso back into his own end with a pass ahead. That's offside as looping inside the blue line was Kuznetsov. 5:09 to go in this first period. Still scoreless here in the opening frame, although Danbury has had the better of the chances so far. The River Dragons are starting to get it going a little bit, finding some momentum. Ising will put the faceoff to the right of Brian Wilson in the hat trick's cage. Heitzner can't win it back. And now it'll be pushed out. And a pass intended for DeBenedict, tip behind him. He'll cycle it back to the D. And now Jemayev stepping up. Knock the puck loose, but again, Danbury on it. Hattricks are doing a nice job of recovering stuff in their own end. And now Jemayev had a stick knocked away from him all the way into the offensive zone. Wanted a penalty for that. Doesn't get it. And now, well, actually, no. Check that. There is a penalty. And now Jemayev is mugged at the front of the net. And Jemayev is going to go. Mitts are off. He and Pamaleon. And they'll throw the rights at one another. Jemayev has had enough. Pamaleon is knocked back by Jemayev, who ends up on top of him. Well, Jemayev had three Danbury players end up on top of him. Underwood ends up pushing along with Gesso. So I don't know if we are going to end up with that initial power play, but I believe there was going to be a penalty coming. Now it was very late in coming, but I think there was one coming against Danbury for knocking the stick away from Jemayev. And indeed, they have two players in the box. So 4:38 to go in the first. We are scoreless. Let's take a break. We'll come back with more in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Face it, you've been borrowing your buddy's tractor long enough. It's time to get your own John Deere from SunSouth. And SunSouth makes owning a John Deere easy and affordable with financing as low as 0% interest. Right now, you can drive off in a 1-series tractor with loader starting around $200 a month. But watch out, when you have a John Deere, your friends may start appearing out of nowhere. For quality John Deere equipment, visit SunSouth. Equipment for those that...
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires January 31, 2023.
For Beam, community isn't just a place. It's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964. Not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business. Beam. Bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
We are back. Columbus River Dragons hockey here at Danbury Arena. Tom Callahan here with you in the Sun South John Deere first period. Thanks for joining us as it looks like the extra 2 minutes is going up there for Kuznetsov. That was the initial penalty call coming up. Pamaleon and Jemayev will pick up 5 for fighting. Well, now Jemayev's got another 2 on his side of the board. For what? Taking punches? Are we really going to even this up? 4:38 to go in the first period. They are going to even it up. I don't even understand how, but all right. They haven't listed the other two minors yet. So 4-on-4 hockey for the next 2 minutes. And it looks like Heitzner will go in to sit with Jemayev. If Jemayev gets an instigator here and he was basically getting pushed around by 4 orange jerseys. We'll talk about it in a minute. LaBelle in with a shot in the right pad, saved by Wilson. A lot of ice out there. Here's Wickline feeding it in front. A chance. Albert cutting across. Couldn't get it on goal. Albert moving across the blue line. Wrist shot back across the green and a right pad saved by Wilson. Albert on his own rebound. Up top is Wickline. Wickline looking across the ice into the slot. LaBella shot. That one hit Aldworth. Caroms away to the wall. Aldworth on it, feeding it for Wickline. That bounced away from him onto the near side. That one is cleared to center. LaBelle took a knee, blocked it. River Dragons trying to turn back in quickly. Here's Aldworth weaving through traffic. Aldworth on the right side. Knocked down, got it to the right wing corner. Wickline on it over there. And here's Aldworth chasing behind the net. Aldworth backhand over to Wickline near side. Wickline feeding the right point. Greco settles a puck, flings it around the dasher. River Dragons trying to get a change on here. Rogers looking for Storjan coming in. Rogers at the blue line, fires it to the far corner. The River Dragons able to change out their lines. Well, Storjan blindly fed it to the point. Greco was the last guy to change, and the puck off the ice. 44 seconds to go on the 4-on-4. Scoreless in the first. Time winding down, 3:20 and counting. Petrantonio leading the charge in, but had it knocked off his stick behind the net. Kelly couldn't get to it in time. And now Danbury able to move it to center. Falanga looping back with it. He'll try to attack on the left wing. Cuts wide, off-angle chance. Colgan will hold. Just absorbing that one off the body. Pretty simple shutdown on the wing for Brendan Colgan. As we mentioned, if you like goaltending, well, they both got unsportsmanlike. Jemayev got unsportsmanlike, Kuznetsov got unsportsmanlike. Four on four for the next 19 seconds. Brought up the left side. Here's Kelly. Kelly in over the line, feeding it up top. Rogers a shot. That one tipped away by the blocker of Wilson. Now back the other way. Here's Lugo, right wing, cutting in. Lugo, high slot, and that wrister is tipped out of play. Faceoff will stay to the left of Colgan. 2 seconds in the 4-on-4, and then go back to, well, 5-on-5. I won't guarantee the rest of the period. It's getting a little finicky out there. Actually, looking at a team like Danbury with almost 1,000 minutes in penalties this year, I'm surprised it hasn't started a little earlier, but now we're back at 5-on-5. Coming up on 2.5 to go here in this opening frame. Benelli, bank it to center, Heitzner on it. That one sent in from center by Underwood. Puck in behind the net. Moving over after it, Doe. Pushes it around to the far side. Benelli keeping it in at the right point. Here's Doe into the slot. Knocked away there. And it is cleared up and over the head of Benelli. Down the ice. He will chase. Colgan playing into the side of the net. So there is no icing. River Dragons on the regroup here. Kind of reset something. Move it ahead. Here's Heitzner in with a shot tipped onto the glass. Puck fed to the slot, deflected away from Krupp. Frazier now, here's a break going the other way, and a chance for Kuznetsov moving in with a shot way out to greet it. Colgan able to get a piece and tip it to the glass. A big hit attempt on the far side, misses, and there's a lead. That one was never going to catch its intended target. That was Heitzner, who was out of gas, just wanted to get to the bench. And instead it turns into an icing call. Back into the River Dragons end of things with 1:27 to go in the first period. And a very tired Kyle Heitzner has to go back out there with some of his line mates and try to get through it here. Tied up on the dot. And the puck shoved back into the corner. Benelli wants to move it along. Wickline on the far side after it. Wickline put it right in front of his own net, but it worked out as Frazier able to move it ahead. Frazier onto the right wing side, back for Wickline off his skate. River Dragons will finish up that change they started before the icing. As Aldworth finally out there with his line mates. Down to 1 minute to go in the first.
1 minute remaining in the first period. 1 minute.
Now on the right wing side. Kuznetsov, a little shake and bake, moves his way into the wing, and that shot tipped way into the netting off the stick of LaBelle. 49.7 left to go. Stay tuned for the Chick-fil-A First Period Intermission Report. Our guest will be Lane King joining us. We'll have a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, plus a recap of what happened in this period. That out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by Zelmo Zippin, the official fuel provider of the Columbus River Dragons. Here's LaBelle on the left wing. Past Kelly it goes. Is it icing? No. Storjahan beat it out. King in the corner. Can the River Dragons find one late here? Nope. Turned over to Danbury. They go back the other way, led by Falanga on the right wing. He cuts in over the line. Falanga on the backhand, behind the net, out the far side with it. Still has it on the backhand, all the way to the left point. Just hooks it to the right wing. There it is, picked up by LaBelle. LaBelle will rush it to center. Try to push it along. It ends up just inside the Danbury line, and they bank it back. That should be icing. Nope, they wave it off. LaBelle, 7 seconds, six, and I would not be surprised to see the River Dragons just run it out here, and they will. So that is the end of period number one. Scoreless so far, 20 minutes into it here from Danbury Arena. As both teams head off into the sunset of that Sun South John Deere first period of play. We'll move on into our first intermission report brought to you by Chick-fil-A. And again, when we come back, Lane King is our guest. He will join us next. Stay tuned. There's more coming your way in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're going to get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
At Mr. Sparky, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
Oral and maxillofacial surgeons Mark Zawicki, Lee Allen practice a traditional scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery with over 60 years of combined expertise, ranging from oral pathology to wisdom tooth removal. They perform a full range of dental implant and bone grafting procedures, as well as non-invasive surgical facial cosmetic procedures. That level of expertise is why the River Dragons trust them. Call them in Columbus at 596-1757 or in LaGrange at 884-2655.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
When the River Dragons have a breakdown, the puck can end up in the back of the net. But when your car has a breakdown, you need a reliable tow partner. Trust the tow company the River Dragons depend on, Tuffy's Towing. Tuffy's tows many types of vehicles in the Chattahoochee Valley. Call 706-457-0985 for a quote or go online to tuffystowing.com. Tuffy's, we tow more than just cars.
Welcome back to the first period intermission report brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We're joined by Lane King. And Lane, first of all, thanks for joining us. How are things going for you lately?
Things are good. Yeah, I mean, we're in the meat of our season right now. You know, the end is approaching. So we're just kind of getting ready, fine tuning things for the long haul here, the final push.
Danbury's a tough team, second best team in the league. And coming into this weekend set, I'm sure there's a little bit of thinking back to what it was like when these guys came to Columbus. Talk to us about your preparation.
Yeah, I think, you know, the first game they got us in a shootout. And then I think we got them at the second night in regulation. But they're a good team. They moved the puck well. They're really well coached. Coach Bill McCurry always has them ready to play. He has them in good spots. So it's always a tough game, especially when you come to their rink.
What do you guys have to highlight?
I think we just need to take care of our own end. You know, one of our inconsistencies this year has been the D zone as a whole unit, though, not just our defensemen. So I think, you know, cleaning up a couple things in the D zone, just
minimize some mistakes that will allow us to use our creativity on the other end.
All right, Kinger, thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, we're back with more of the Chick-fil-A First Intermission Report in just a moment.
Fleet Tire and Service, located at 3109 Victory Drive in Columbus, is the perfect place to take care of everything your vehicle needs. From preventive maintenance to alignments, brakes, oil changes, and more, your friends at Complete Tire and Service have you covered. Need tires? Buy three, get one free for passenger vehicles. Call 706-321-8133 to set up your appointment. 321-8133. Complete Tire and Service on the web at ctstires.com.
Hydrolife Fair Therapy at Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, Hydrolive treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the IV League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at hydrolifetherapy.com/Columbus. Hydrolive Therapy. Start living your best life.
While the River Dragons handle pest on the ice, Orkin takes care of rodents and pest at your home or business. Locally owned and operated, Orkin creates a custom pest plan specifically for you. Orkin can help eliminate and control mice, bed bugs, ants, roaches, stinging insects, and cockroaches, just to name a few. Remember, they're not happy until you're happy, so visit Orkin.com for a free estimate and trust the only pest control service the Dragons trust, Orkin. Now, if they could just control seawolves and thunderbirds...
Heroes of Valhalla is your go-to place for all of your gunsmithing and firearms needs. They also specialize in Cerakote finishing as well as hydro dipping, which offers over 1,000 different pattern options. Check them out online at heroesofvalhalla.us or stop by the shop at 6320 Bradley Park Drive in Columbus. They're open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Online at heroesofvalhalla.us.
In 1999, Whatley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
Let's go!
Period intermission report. Tom Callahan here with you and brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Take a look inside the numbers from that first period of play. And no scoring to tell you about. Each team picked up a minor and a major, but there were no power plays either. It was a little scrap towards the end of 15-22. Jemayev ended up throwing punches with Pamaleon, but that scrap also carried with it two other minors and unsportsmanlike conduct. Now, that was on Kuznetsov for knocking Jemayev's stick away from him in the first place, and then somewhere along the line, Jemayev also picked up an unsportsmanlike conduct, and so we ended up with everything even, 4-on-4, and the River Dragons did have some scoring opportunities during that 4-on-4, but they were unable to convert. In fact, the shots finish 11-9 in favor of the hometown team here. Danbury with that slight edge. But at one point in the period, shots were 8-1 in favor of Danbury. And so the River Dragons really closed that gap before the end of the period. And again, that's what I was talking about exactly in the first period, is that the River Dragons are a team that kind of hangs out sometimes for that first 10 minutes of the first period. They don't really get in there. And that, again, after a long trip, that's the bus legs theory. But they get better as the game goes along. They keep getting stronger and stronger, which, again, not a bad trait to have. In fact, it's an excellent one. But for the River Dragons, you know, to know that you, instead of being able to come out guns blazing, you have to kind of work your way up to it. I don't necessarily know that frustrating is the right word. Because it's not when you're a good hockey team, that's not really a frustrating thing, but it is something that, how do you get to that 60 minutes of completeness from the 50? Maybe you get it to 55, 57 minutes, but you really want that 60-minute effort, and that's where the River Dragons just trying to figure out exactly how they can get it to that point. And Columbus, at this point, have not scored here against Danbury, but they've also kept the high-flying hat tricks off the board against them as well. And as the Zamboni circles the ice here at the Danbury Arena, kind of actually a quiet and a bit of a tame, dare I say it, first period. Not a whole lot going on there, and not even really a lot of hitting in this one. These two teams kind of to get feisty with each other back in Columbus. We haven't really seen much of that here tonight, or really the hint of it, except for that one fight. But again, Jemayev dropped the gloves after he was surrounded by himself by four orange jerseys, decided he'd had enough. And off you go from that. But I just haven't seen a lot of it. Now, there has been some talking here and there between the benches. But it really makes me interested to see what direction this game is going to go here in periods number two and three. And I dare say, if it stays away from more of the physical stuff, that definitely favors the River Dragons. So let's see if Columbus might be able to keep that on their side here. And I believe when you get a team like Danbury that takes a lot of penalties and is used to killing those penalties off, is used to the rough stuff, is used to engaging in that, perhaps when they don't get that, it keeps them out of their rhythm. They are more accustomed to goading teams into accepting their way of play. I did not see that from the River Dragons, so to me, that's all good things, and that's a great sign here early on in this first period. But we have a lot more hockey to go, and I could talk about this right now, and then in the second period, we could have five fights in the first 5 minutes. I don't know. But right now, the River Dragons are doing a nice job out there. And so let's take a look at our Zelmo Zip In Out-of-Town scoreboard. Zelmo's has been fueling life's passions since 1999, catching up with some of the other games going on in the FPHL tonight. Three other contests to tell you about. And let's check in on Binghamton and Delaware. And the Black Bears have a 2-0 lead over the Delaware Thunder right now. That one is about halfway home in the second period. And so the River Dragons have not seen either of those two teams yet this year, but Delaware will be coming to town the next time the River Dragons are back home. That is going to be the weekend of the 17th, 18th, and 19th. Talk about what's going on that weekend. Military Appreciation Night on the 18th. But in the meantime, Binghamton is up 2-0 there. That game's in the second. Motor City has a 1-0 lead over Elmira. That is after the first period of play. And Watertown out to a 2-1 lead late in the first period against Carolina. Wow, look at you, Watertown. All right. Now, in the NHL, there's nothing going on tonight unless you like the skills competition, in which case, DVR that, and you can watch it later. Stay with us here for River Dragons Hockey. But they have that going on tonight. And then tomorrow, the NHL All-Star Game kicks off at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. And that'll feature the teams from the divisions going against one another. The Central faces the Pacific first, and then the Metropolitan and the Atlantic come in after that. And it becomes basically like a little tournament. Whoever wins those two games will then face off for the, I guess, victory celebration at the All-Star Game. But it's always fun to watch those players put their ample skill sets on display. And then we're back at you tomorrow night here. And that one will be a 7 o'clock puck drop tomorrow night here from Danbury Arena. So looking forward to a fun weekend of hockey here. And that's it for our Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. And I'm going to keep reminding you throughout both broadcasts this weekend, it's your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey, which will be delivered before the end of the regular season. If you do not order by this Sunday, February 5th, we cannot guarantee that your customized jersey with any name and number, which shows everyone how much you love the River Dragons, will be delivered before the end of the season. Go to rdragonsmerch.com. That's the letter R, dragonsmerch.com, to place your order today. Again, last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. So you can't say that Tom Callahan didn't warn you. I am shouting it for the mountaintops, or at least I am through my headset. So, Drew, did you get your custom jersey order in? I hope you did. If you don't do it by Sunday, you're not getting your jersey on time. Drew Pierce, our executive producer, just shaking his head at me right here. All right, that'll do it for our Chick-fil-A first period intermission report. When we come back, we'll drop the puck on second period action. Stick around. There's more Columbus River Dragons hockey coming your way.
Hello there. My name is Seychelle, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the punch of flavors that's unlike any other. You get the crispy tenderness of the chicken and that hint of sourness from the pickles. Ta-da!
Hey, I'm Juan, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is you know you're going to get chicken that's crispy, golden, and juicy. This is the gold standard of chicken sandwiches.
Order the original Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real customers paid for their testimonials.
Hello to all your River Dragons fans. Chief Meteorologist Eric Kincaid here in the Storm Team 9 Alert Center with a look at your forecast. Now, if you're heading out on the town tonight, don't forget those jackets. Temperatures dropping from the 40s down to the low to mid 30s as the night progresses, and the wind's going to make it feel like the 20s for much of the night. Skies stay clear. There'll be no need for any umbrellas as we finally start to dry out a bit. Now, for your Saturday, we're going to see temperatures starting out at or below freezing in many places. The feels like temperatures in the 20s, but look for sunny skies for the first part of the day. Highs topping out in the mid-50s, and later into Saturday evening and night, clouds increase, but we are going to keep the forecast dry. Temperatures in the 30s again early Sunday, but we should see highs back in the upper 50s and low 60s by the afternoon under a mostly cloudy sky, but we still expect conditions to stay dry on Sunday. Next week starts out dry, and there'll be a warm-up on Monday and Tuesday. Highs upper 60s, low 70s. They get ready for some rain by the middle and end of next week. Track it for free on the WTVN Weather app, and we're back. Columbus River Dragons Broadcast Network.
Hey guys, this is Mike Hostolo of the Mike Hostolo Law Firm.
It's Rick Willis of the Mike Hostolo Law Firm.
Did you know that car accidents are the number one case of injuries in the U.S.? So if you find yourself in a car wreck,
call or text me at 844-GET-MIKE or visit us at MikeHostoloLawFirm.com.
So do yourself a favor and I hope that you learn. Been in the wreck, call the Mike Hostolo Law Firm.
So if you've been injured, please give us a call.
Let's have a conversation.
Michael G. Hostolo, 1301 First Avenue, Suite 101, Columbus, 31901.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside. Technology with a human touch.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com. Or call 706-324-6661.
Bye.
set it up into the left half wall. And now some rotation going on here onto the right wing. Here's Wickline. Aldworth at the right point. Leaving for Wickline, it goes to the right point. Aldworth to the right half wall. Cross ice feed. Shot by Vanelli. Save made. Wilson catching with a glove, holding on. Nowhere for that one to go. Draw will come up to the right. Bob Wilson, seven gone here in the second period. 119 to go with the holding call against the Danbury Hattricks. Krupp on the puck, left side on the half boards. Krupp into the corner after it. Now it's fed back up top. A roller to the line, not out. Held in by Wickline across Vanelli, but that pass he was letting it go to Frazier was deflected out. Now Vanelli lost the handle on it as he's pressured back into the corner by Falenga. And now he'll step away with it. Vanelli, cross ice. Krupp fed it back to nobody, and it goes all the way back into the River Dragon zone. Well, the focus is just not there right now. Vanelli, right side to Frazio. He'll move it ahead. Carried into the right side, centering feet. Kicked away by Wilson, a backhand by Krupp. Wilson save coming to his right. Frazio up top to Kelly. Kelly wrister tipped out of play. Tried to sneak that one through from up high, and it was tipped out. 30 seconds to go on the man advantage. The Georgia Power power play first chance for either side tonight. Danbury with a 1-0 lead. 7:49 gone here in the second period. Drawn to the right of Wilson. Hattricks moved around to the near side corner, and they will try to fling it out. Nope, that blocked and kept in. Yes, Greco on the right side. Swinging into the far corner. Kelly chasing it down, tying up with his man over there, looking for a little help from King. Kelly backhanding it around to the left point, LaBelle. 10 seconds of the power play. Storage of hand at the right point, rotating. Moving it across, shot through traffic, blocked in front. Cleared along the wall. Storage of hand has to peel back after the rolling puck. Ran into the linesman trying to get back for it. And now here come the Hattricks in. And a chance in front. That one is taken away. Nice job by LaBelle in a back check. Just confusion there. King will dump it in cross corner. Kelly up after it. That one seemed to wake the crowd up. Left side, here's LaBelle at the left point. Into the corner now. Rolls around to the near side. Chemaev trying to catch up with the puck. Cannot. It's cleared away. LaBelle on it at center. Dumps it right back in from the stripe. Wilson on to the near side. And now looping away with it, Borshev. Up through center, here comes Danbury. Into the right wing. Lugo feeding it behind the net, onto the near side. Heitzner sending it right back behind Petrantonio off the left side of the cage, ahead to Jemayev. Jemayev steps up. Left wing Doe. Doe into the corner after it. You know, sometimes it's a big hit that wakes a game up. But I can't tell you the last time a big hit on a linesman woke a game up. But that's exactly what happened after Storage of Hand ran into the linesman. All of a sudden, the last minute, there's a lot more energy in this building. Hattricks trying to move it in from center. Cut off by Petrantonio at center. And now tossed right back in. Rogers has to give chase behind the Columbus net. Onto the right wing, Heitzner. Cross ice feed, here's Doe after the rolling puck. Doe lost it, Jemayev will send it in. Around behind the net it goes. And now back out to center, Frazio on it. Tried to turn it back in, he gets it sent back to it. Here's Aldworth. Aldworth stepping ahead. Left side on the backhand. Poked off his stick. And cleared out of the zone. Vanelli leaving it at center. The regroup. Frazio try the left side. Aldworth steps in with Wickline. Aldworth the Wickline to Aldworth. Dot a shot! And that one is fought off by Wilson. Danbury back the other way. They'll scoop it in around the glass and out of play. 9:15 to go in the second period. 1-0. Hattricks in the lead. We'll take a break and come back with more River Dragons hockey. Sponsored by
River Dragons Hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like Chuck-a-Pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
And we are back here at Danbury Arena. Tom Callahan here with you, and it's time for God Bless America. I don't think I've ever heard a version as chipper as that. Kind of an interesting one. Had a little bit of polka in its blood. 9:15 to go in the second period. The second period brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. Tom Callahan here broadcasting live from the Harvey Lumber Press Box. Harvey Lumber serving the community for over 150 years. 1-0. The score. The hat tricks. Scoring off a deflection, Marchessault 16th from Richards at 5:37 here. The second period is the only difference. And Vanelli sending it over to the left side. Here's Frazio. Frazio ahead looking for Wickline. Bounced away from him. He'll chase into the right side. Wickline into the corner. Spins backhand, and that one never made it through. Wickline knocked down to the corner. Gets up. He's all right. Gesso in on the left wing side. Into the corner it goes, shouldering with Vanelli. Frazio up the near side, Wickline tipping it on. Here's Aldworth. Aldworth skips around to check, continues after the puck into the right side corner. Aldworth leaving it side of the net. Wickline in with a chance. Wilson to save. Left point Vanelli on the backhand, keeps it down low. Wickline tried to send it back up the wall. That one poked along. Vanelli kicked it in. Now stretch behind it. Here's Gesso in on a break. Gesso in with a shot. Save Colgan. Penalty coming up on Frazio. Penalty or penalty shot? Nope, hooking. Gesso wanted a penalty shot. That was interesting. Gesso just made a gesture with his hands like he wanted it to go to VAR. Which, if you're an English Premier League soccer fan, you know that that's their replay system. But the first power play of the game for the Danbury hat tricks is because of Frazio's hook to break up that scoring chance. 11:37, time of the penalty. And it is the first Franklin Financial penalty kill. Personal loans at the speed of life. Danbury's power play this year, eighth in the league at 7th in the league at 16%. River Dragons second on the kill at 86.4%. That would have sent down the ice and will be chased down there by Gonzalez. It's kind of interesting that these two teams have the ability to score goals like they do, yet the River Dragons are 8th and the Danbury hat trick 7th on the power play. Yet Columbus 2nd on the penalty kill and Danbury 3rd on the penalty kill. Make of that what you will. LaBelle set it down the ice. Look out, that ends up in the River Dragons bench. Kelly tried to tip it and keep it in play. Faceoff will come to the right of Brendan Colgan. 1:20 to go in the hooking call against Frazio. LaBelle will swing it around the wall after the River Dragons win that faceoff. Danbury will chase it down. 7.5 to go in the second. Patrick's up the right side, pushing it ahead. Belanga stops on the right half wall, looking across the ice. Steps around King, goes to the right corner. Fed towards the point, Gesso. Leaving it off on that right side wall, Kuznetsov to the right point himself. Gesso now to the left point. Can't shoot. Puts it back up top. Ends up back with Gesso. Now over to the right point. Pamaleon switches with him. Feeds to the far dot. Belanga slot. Kuznetsov's one-time shot. A stick save there for Colgan. Puck in the left wing corner. Push behind the net over to the far side. Greco with a big hit there, and he's going to get penalized for it. Greco with a hit that knocked down Borshev. I can't wait to see what this is. Roughing. Unbelievable. You cannot hit anymore. I don't know how that's roughing. It was a hit. Can we not hit? Are you not allowed to hit in hockey anymore? I honestly don't know what the standard is. So 5-on-3 for 15 seconds until Frazier returns from his hooking call. Huge faceoff here. Petrantonio to take it. One back by Danbury. McDonald swings it over to the right point. He'll get it back at the left. Through traffic, a shot. Left pad save, Colgan. And that one is cleared down the ice by Doe. Frazier up on his skates, ready to come onto the box. And so the 5-on-3 is over. Frazier will have to stay on the ice here as the attack looming at the line and now chipped into the Danbury bench. That will allow the River Dragons to put out the four penalty killers they'd like. Jemayev and Heitzner out along with Rogers and Petrantonio. Draw one back. Rogers on it, curling away from pressure, but his clear is disrupted, doesn't leave the zone. Kept in on the left side. De Benedict up top, now over to the right side for one time. Colgan easily over to his left. Not really challenged on that one by McDonald from the far dot. Colgan is a big goaltender, and really, he moves so smooth that it almost doesn't look like he is moving sometimes. He just glides over one side to the other, but his positioning is so good. And he makes saves like that, which aren't easy. He makes them look very easy just because he's so technically proficient with his lateral movement. Here's Petrantonio stepping up at center, cutting it over the line with a wrist shot and a right pad save there. Wilson, Petrantonio trying to cut it off on the wall, kicks it in behind the net. He ends up in the near corner, just cycles it down low. Heitzner over to the left side after 52 seconds to go on the power play here for the Hattricks, their second consecutive. The first one killed off, thanks Abercrombie-Bondic. Puck to the right point, Vanelli with a drive, and he fanned on it, but it floated in. And actually a more dangerous scoring chance in the slot. Heitzner with a shot, that's also tipped in, but Wilson able to handle. And he hangs on. Now a little crowd to the front of the net. 33 seconds left to go, and the penalty for roughing against Greco. 5:12 to go in the second, 1-0. Danbury in the lead. Draw will come to the left of the Hattricks net. Underwood, Doe, Vanelli, Frazier out there. And Underwood winning it to Vanelli, who tried a shot. That one was blocked off the stick of Belanga. And Danbury recovers. They'll head behind their own net to regroup. Puck at center is picked off and bounced right back into the Danbury end, so the Hattricks will try the left side this time. Gesso over skates. Doe trying to pick it away in his skates, and Doe is able to at least knock it over the line. 3 seconds to go And now the power play is over. Greco returns. River Dragons 2-for-2 on the penalty kill. Thanks to Abercrombie Bonding for another successful penalty kill. And Greco goes out, throws a hit back there behind the net, running into Pamaleon. Puck stays in. Right side, Greco lets it go. And a left pad save by Wilson. Puck up the near side. Greco goes after Pamaleon again. Frazio holding it to the right point. Here's Greco up top, feeding left side to Aldworth. Aldworth rolling puck. Roller in front. Wickline was knocked down. Still got a tip on it, but couldn't get it to go. Danbury trying to leave the zone. And, well, that one somehow is cleared out. Vanelli, though, fires it right back in. Now the ricochet up the slot. Wickline in with a shot, and that's handled by Wilson. It kicked off the puck board right up the slot to Wickline, but Wilson quickly out on the angle. He makes the stop. 3:52 to go in the second period. 1-0. Danbury in the lead. We're back with more in just a moment. This is River Dragons hockey. It's hockey.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
So you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 800 15th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
Back here at Danbury Arena, Tom Callahan here with you as it is a 1-0 hat tricks lead. If you took the over on whatever this game is, we are not there right now. Just one goal so far. Puck put down in the Danbury end, and the hat tricks win the draw as they'll try to move it ahead. Pushing up on the right wing side, puck left off up top. A shot, right pad save. Colgan rebound up the slot, scooped up by Aldworth. They'll play it behind, looking for Rogers. It rolls away from him to the far side corner. McKittrick on it, fed to the right point. That one golfed way high over the net. Bouncing at the side of the goal, ends up behind. Petrantonio ends up knocking it out of play. Let's take a break right now. 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2, Fort Benning South, Columbus. And W295AY, Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
27 to go in our second period here, presented by Kinetic Credit Union. Tom Callahan here with you. 3:20 and counting left to go in the second period. 1-0 Danbury is thrown in from center by Storjahan. Wilson out to scoop it around to the near side. And that puck ends up at center. Greco will fire it right back in. River Dragons must tag it up. Lugo got knocked down after running into Greco, tried to throw the bump on him at center. After he dumped it in, Greco's a very hard player to run into. Long shot in, that floats wide of Colgan. LaBelle chops it up the far wall. Valanga keeping it in. LaBelle after it, moving it back towards Kelly. Kelly corrals his pass right side, Storjahan after it. Storjahan walks in over the line. Back to Kelly, left side, approaching in the slot. Turn around, looking for Storjahan, puck tip wide. And Danbury feeding to an open wing, but Kelly turns around, he'll keep it in. Kelly on the right wing, trying to cut through traffic, feeds it over to Storjahan. Storjahan looking for some options. Right point goes to Greco. He fires it low, looking for a bank pass. King. King on the far side corner. Storjahan bounced away from him, up to the line. Greco able to keep it in. Now stepping up is Kelly on the right side. Loops high over. One time King, and that one deflected off a defender's stick. Puck ends up in the near corner. Danbury trying to move it out. Greco steps up, keeps the play alive. Storjahan at the line. Roller sent it down low. Kelly into the right side corner. This line is gassed, but they still have possession. King, left point, LaBelle, wrist shot block. Another chance, that one tipped into the netting. That was the kind of dominant shift the River Dragons needed to snatch the momentum back in this hockey game. 1:55 to go in the second, 1-0. Danbury in the lead, but Boy, oh boy, the River Dragons needed that kind of possession. See if they could build off the momentum here. Danbury winning the draw, cleared to the line, but right at Vannelli. Vannelli sweeps it right back in. Behind the net it goes around to the far side, and this time Danbury able to clear it out. Frazio turning to try to go with Gesso, cutting in on net. He got it across, and Colgan a right pad save there. Rebound up towards Kuznetsov, leaving it on the left side. McDonald wheeling in for the point, wanted to get it back door. Gesso was wide open, nobody on him, but the pass couldn't find him. River Dragons fortunate there. Right side pushed in by Heitzner from center. He'll go in behind, leaving it near side. It didn't get to Jemayev. Chipped away to the wall, and now sent down the ice. Frazio turning for it. Frazio right side, Krupp tipping it ahead. Kuznetsov ends up with it at center, throws it back into the Columbus end. No icing. And now 1 minute to go in the second period. 1-0 Danbury. Here's Wick line up on the forecheck here. Coming straight off the change, went off his mitt. Ends up with Marchessault. Now onto the left wing side, carrying that one wide. A chance in front. Oh, Colgan! Able to reach back and punch it out of the air with a blocker as he left the post on the near side. Dangerous chance there and a smart one by Richards. Rogers, cross corner, looking for Krupp. Puck in over the line. Krupp trying to knock it away from Gonzalez. Gonzalez up the far wall. Kept in. Petrantonio the point. Long shot in and Wilson a glove save. 24.4 seconds to go in the second period. 1-0 Danbury. Face-off will be to the right of the hat tricks net. River Dragons will send back Storjahan, King, and Kelly out there, who had a very good shift last time out. Might as well see if they can find a little magic here in the last 20 or so. Danbury starts with a draw win, however. This swinging around to the right point. Rogers can't hold it in. Now 2-on-1 up the left side. Marchessault moving in, slides it in front. Kelly on the back check, able to poke that puck away from McKittrick. And now the puck off a stanchion off the top of the net, right up the front. And now batted back towards the River Dragons' net. Columbus will just try to run out the clock, and they do. Let's get into the intermission. Well, a much better period for Danbury as they get the lone goal here. The River Dragons, well, moving in fits and starts as far as momentum and trying to make some things happen, but they still don't happen to have an answer for goaltender Brian Wilson. 40 minutes into it. Danbury's got the lead. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll move on into our second intermission report. And that is brought to you by Shredaway. We'll look inside the numbers, recap the scoring, plus a look at that Zelmo zipping out of town scoreboard. All that and more is coming your way in just a moment. And you are listening to Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
The Overby Company take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
Heroes of Valhalla is your go-to place for all of your gunsmithing and firearms needs. They also specialize in Cerakote finishing as well as hydro dipping, which offers over 1,000 different pattern options. Check them out online at heroesofvalhalla.us or stop by the shop at 6320 Bradley Park Drive in Columbus. They're open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Online at heroesofvalhalla.us. Craving a burrito, some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Bar Burritos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom made how you want it on the spot. Bar Burritos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at barburritos.com or through our handy mobile app. Bar Burritos. Food, community, people.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time. And we're available 24/7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
Oral and maxillofacial surgeons Mark Sawicki, Lee Allen practice a traditional scope of oral and maxillofacial surgery with over 60 years of combined expertise, ranging from oral pathology to wisdom tooth removal. They perform a full range of dental implant and bone grafting procedures, as well as non-invasive surgical facial cosmetic procedures. That level of expertise is why the River Dragons trust them. Call them in Columbus at 596-1757 or in LaGrange at 884-2655.
Hello, it's all you River Dragons fans. Chief Meteorologist Eric Kincaid here in the Storm Team 9 Alert Center with a look at your forecast. Now, if you're heading out on the town tonight, don't forget those jackets. Temperatures dropping from the 40s down to the low to mid 30s as the night progresses, and the wind's going to make it feel like the 20s for much of the night. Skies stay clear. There'll be no need for any umbrellas as we finally start to dry out a bit. Now, for your Saturday, we're going to see temperatures starting out at or below freezing in many places. The feels like temperatures in the 20s, but look for sunny skies for the first part of the day. Highs topping out in the mid-50s, and later into Saturday evening and night, clouds increase, but we are going to keep the forecast dry. Temperatures in the 30s again early Sunday, but we should see highs back in the upper 50s and low 60s by the afternoon under a mostly cloudy sky, but we still expect conditions to stay dry on Sunday. Next week starts out dry, and there'll be a warm-up on Monday and Tuesday. Highs upper 60s, low 70s. They get ready for some rain by the middle and end of next week. Track it for free on the WTVN Weather app, and we're back. Columbus River Dragons Broadcast Network.
So light 'em up, I'm on fire. So light 'em up, I'm on fire.
And welcome back here in the second period intermission report brought to you by Shredaway. Tom Callahan here with you, and it's a 1-0 Danbury hat tricks lead as the Chuck-a-pucks rain down here along with a couple assorted carrots, which we saw hit the ice earlier after the goal scored by Danbury. And right now for the River Dragons, they have their work cut out for them. And it's really hard to figure out to a certain extent if the credit is due more to Danbury for smothering the River Dragons' offensive output or if the impetus is more on Columbus to try to generate a little more heat offensively. Now, certainly both of those could be true at the same time as well, but the River Dragons, probably one or two good shifts in that period. But when you look at what Danbury did, Danbury really took advantage of the fact that the River Dragons did not have a great time getting pucks deep, and even when they did, they had a difficult time hitting the opposing blue line with speed, with momentum to try to get into the corner and make something happen down there. They were unable to generate some time of possession off those things. We saw a shift late in the period where they did. The Storjahan-Kelly-King line did generate some nice time of possession. They really finally were able to get a little something going here, but those shifts have been few and far between in this game. And for the River Dragons, trying to establish that zone time is something that, first of all, you know that they want to do. And it's something that is always high on the game plan. Get the pucks in, make things happen. And really try to do your absolute best to just jam it up in the corner, use some numbers, and then get things going. And they have really struggled with that one here so far in this game, and it's shown up in the scoring chances, I think. Not so much the shots. Shots in that period were 12-9 in favor of Danbury. For the hockey game, they're 23-18. And it sounds like Columbus is not there that far off. And indeed, they may not be that far off. And they do have a shift here, a shift there, where they certainly put the pressure on this hat tricks team. But again, facing one of the top goaltenders in the league in Brian Wilson, a guy who just finds a way to keep those pucks out. He's got 16 wins coming into tonight. That is tops in the league. And at this point, Wilson is going to continue to give them the saves they need, especially when a lot of times the target, he hasn't really even had to use his hands that much or his pads. It's been a lot of into the chest. Goaltenders are going to stop those all day long. If you're trying to find a leaker maybe between the arm and the body, that's more of a either get lucky or get a quick shot or maybe even something deflected that finds its way in that way. Right now, back in the first period, I talked about the bugaboo for Danbury was not finding the net whatsoever. For the River Dragons, it's they find the goaltender. And part of that, again, is Wilson aggressive, out on his angle, plays big even when he's down and out. He stays square and he stays upright to the shooter. So that's something I think the River Dragons really need to consider. On the flip side of that, the River Dragons getting an excellent performance once again out of Brendan Colgan, but are allowing Danbury a little bit more quality chances. And so for the River Dragons, they certainly want to stop those from happening. And they do give up the only goal of the period. Bit of a fluke goal, though, as the shot coming in front from Michael Marchessault, I believe it was actually intended to be more of a pass. I think he was trying to put the puck back door. But it glanced in off the defender, Paul Frazio, as he was backing up on the play. And it caroms past Colgan. Not a lot you can do when it changes direction like that. And that's been the only goal of the game. They have added an assist on that play to Luke Richards. And so it is Richards, the assist on that Marchessault goal at 5:37 of the second. And that's the only goal to speak of. In the second period, we did get some power plays. And the River Dragons 0-1 with the man advantage. The Danbury Hattricks 0-2. And again, interesting that two teams that score as much as these two teams do and are very good offensively, both of them have lower-ranked power plays but top-ranked penalty kills. And so strength on strength there. And the effectiveness of those top-rated penalty kills has been on display here at Danbury Arena so far. And so they get the Zamboni out there finally to start the ice up here. And it looks like we're going to have a bit of a delay here, an extended intermission. They just started that 17-minute clock about a minute and a half ago, so it's going to be a little bit here before we get back to third period action. But in the meantime, why don't we step aside for a moment? We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll take a look at the Zelmos zipping out of town scoreboard. And we'll get more for you as things are developing here at Danbury Arena. We will be right back in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. It's hockey.
At the Country Inn and Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
At Mr. Sparky, we're America's on-time electrician. We all count on our home's electrical outlets to provide us the power we need when we need it. But sometimes an overloaded circuit can lead to a blown outlet. So leave it to the pros at Mr. Sparky. We'll get it done right and get it done safely. Call now for $50 off electrical repairs.
You don't have to put up with any malarkey. Call 888-8-SPARKY.
Limitations and restrictions may apply. Independently owned and operated. Licensed in the respective state or county.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time. And we're available 24-7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
in 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We are proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
Welcome back to Danbury Arena. Tom Callahan here with you. 1-0 after 40 minutes of play. Danbury has the lead. And as we recap in the last segment, that goal scored by Marchison deflecting in off of Frazio in front of the net, beating Colgan. So not even really a clean chance. Colgan has played very well tonight, very well. And doing what he always does, giving the River Dragons every save they need and a chance to win hockey games. But now Columbus has got to find a way to dent Brian Wilson. And again, they struggled with getting to Wilson early on in the first matchup back in Columbus. They did manage to break through a little bit later in the game. Hopefully that pattern repeats itself here. You'd really like to see the River Dragons make a little something happen. See if they can try to get a few, not just one, but maybe two or three. And let's not mess around with overtime tonight. Let's just get this one in regulation. Of course, the nice thing is that you're not giving up points to someone in your division, but by the same token, you want to pick up those regulation wins because they are a tiebreak in the FPHL. And should it come down to it, all the way at the end of the season, if these two teams happen to meet, which is certainly a possibility, if you look at the regulation wins right now, Columbus, out of their 26 this year, 23 are in regulation. Danbury has 24 wins, 19 in regulation. So if you're going to do the coin flip over home ice in a potential Commissioner's Cup final matchup, that could be the difference. And so it matters to win that game in regulation. On the other hand, if you're the trailing team, it matters to tie that game up and push it past regulation, even if you do end up ceding that point in overtime, because it's 3 points in the FPHL for a regulation win, 2 if you win an overtime or a shootout, and 1, of course, if you go past regulation and do not win. So that's what the River Dragons and the Hat Tricks are playing for, not only tonight, but the entire season long. Let's take a look at our out-of-town scoreboard, shall we? It's brought to you by Zelmo's Zip-In and 3 other games going on in the FPHL tonight. Taking a look at it right now, Binghamton with a 5-2 lead over the Delaware Thunder. That one is halfway through the third period of that game. Motor City with a 4-2 lead over the Elmira Mammoth. That is after 40 minutes of play, so they'll be heading into the third. And now Watertown and Carolina are tied up at 3. That is towards the end of the second period of play. The National Hockey League tonight is the skills competition. And the All-Star game tomorrow, starting at 3 o'clock Eastern time. It'll be the Central against the Pacific, then the Metropolitan taking on the Atlantic. But tonight, I guess it's the fun stuff for some people. Some fans enjoy it. And there's a little accuracy. Of course, hardest shot is always something that people appreciate and enjoy. And that's always a lot of fun, especially on a night like the All-Star game, which, by the way, I am very jealous of how warm it is in Florida over there for the All-Star game. But it's just absolutely incredible watching the way the show gets put on there. Of course, you see the families and some of the players who have kids have their kids out around it. And that's an absolute blast. And they just look like they're having a good time. That's the important part. It is just having a great time and enjoying yourself and remembering, you know, that hockey is a game and the skill set is just absolutely crazy among some of these players. And watching them be able to just put it on free-flowing display is always entertaining. I don't think the goalies like it. I don't think they're very entertained by the fact that it's pretty much a constant breakaway competition even in the All-Star game, but even they want to put on a show, come up with the big saves. and have a lot of fun doing it. And so hockey is on display this weekend. So again, 3 o'clock tomorrow for that game. Our game here will be at 7 o'clock, 6:30 on the pregame show. And I do want to remind you, if you're a River Dragons fan, I'm going to repeat this a couple more times. This is your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. Customize your jersey with any name and number and show everyone how much you love the River Dragons. Orders must be placed by February 5th to guarantee on-time delivery. Go to rdragonsmerch.com. That's the letter R, dragonsmerch.com, to place your order today. Also, the River Dragons and Air Force Heating and Air want to express our gratitude to our servicemen and women currently defending our freedom. And, of course, our veterans, thank you for your service. And this reminder that River Dragons hockey is brought to you in part by Country Inn and Suites, the official host hotel of the Columbus River Dragons, by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Columbus River Dragons, and by Wade Cleaners, the official cleaners of Scorch and Torch. As the Zamboni circles the ice out here, and we have a chance to get ready to go for period number 3, we're going to step aside. That'll do it for our Shredaway second intermission report. When we come back, we'll prepare for third period action. That's on the other side of the break. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey. It's hockey.
Let Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
River Dragons hockey is more fun in a group. Come celebrate your birthday, anniversary, reunion, and more. Get 10 or more people together to enjoy the best available seating, a special VIP entrance, group recognition at the game, a visit from Scorch or Torch, and more. Plus, you can add on options like chuck-a-pucks, souvenir hats or pucks, and even a team gear shopping spree. Groups of 30 or more get a post-game photo on the ice. Group perks are only available through the River Dragons office by calling 706-507-4625.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside. Technology with a human touch.
Are you ready for it?
The guy was a robber. First time that he saw me, stealing hearts and running off and never.
Dragons hockey, Tom Callahan here with you. We'll get ready for the third period here in just a moment. Brought to you by IGH Properties. This is River Dragons hockey. We appreciate you being here with us. 1-0, Danbury has a lead after 40 minutes of play. Hattricks and River Dragons tonight and tomorrow night to wrap up the regular season series, which the River Dragons have a 1-0-1 mark in. Once again, Captain Josh Petrantonio out on the bench early, just sitting there and kind of taking it all in here in Danbury. The River Dragons will retake the ice here in just a moment, as will the Hat Tricks. Get things going for period number three. Want to say hi once again to our radio side, our flagship station, 106.9 Really Rocks, Columbus's Real Rock Station, and our affiliates at WZEV 90.5 FM, Classic Hits of Lineville, WBRQ 91.9 FM, Blues Time in the City, LaGrange, and WQEE 99.1 FM, home of Southern Sports and Talk in Noonan. And the River Dragons Coaches Show can be heard along the radio network. Presented by Mike Costello Law every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. on 106.9 Really Rocks. And every week, Coach Jerome Bichard joins us and a different player guest, part of the program as well. Then there's the River Dragons TV Coaches Show, which airs every Thursday night at 7 p.m. on CTN Channel 16. We're playing at 11 a.m. on Saturday mornings. Don't miss it. Referees back on the ice, and the Delaware, or pardon me, Danbury coaching staff coming back out. I mean, who knows? The Delaware coaching staff could be here somewhere. Although they are playing tonight, so I doubt it. Petrantonio greeting everyone on the team as they come off the bench. And get ready to go for period number three. River Dragons still looking for the first goal in this hockey game. They were outshot in the second period once again. Not by a lot, but at this point, the River Dragons just trying to figure out a way to maybe get a little more consistency with chances on goal. They had 9 shots in each period so far. They've adjusted that total a little bit, so 18 for the River Dragons. 12 in the second, 11 in the first for Danbury, 23 in the hockey game. But again, at this point, Columbus is trying to figure out whether or not they're going to be able to get it going on a consistent basis. And again, a couple of shifts here, a couple of shifts there. They look good, but it's just not consistent. Danbury making their way back onto the ice here at Danbury Arena. River Dragons in the road whites. Danbury in the home orange. And I have to tell you this, I don't think I have ever seen two teams opposing one another with the city name spelled out in block letters on the front of the jersey, but we have that matchup tonight. Columbus's white road jerseys have Columbus descending from right shoulder to left hip, and Danbury, same thing with these orange jerseys. Danbury spelled out right shoulder to left hip. So here we go, puck drop coming up at center, 5-on-5 hockey to kick off period number three. And again, Danbury for the third straight period wins that opening faceoff. They push in on the right side, Lugo feeding it into the corner. Fresh sheet of ice out there, and Danbury trying to go to work. Puck still tied up in behind the net. The centering feed goes off of Colgan up to the point. Long wrister in. Colgan save, and he pawed it down and covered just in time. Able to bring that rebound in. 25 seconds into the third period, and Danbury starts off with a good first chance. Danbury again winning the faceoff. Quick shot off that draw. Wide on the glove side for Colgan. Pushed out to center by the River Dragons. Doe bounces off a check. Puck still on his skates. They'll feed it back. Frazio moving it ahead to Aldworth. Aldworth, right wing, has Wickline trailing, but was right next to him when he left it for him. Went off all his skates. Got it back down low, though, to Aldworth. Centering feed is knocked away by the goal stick of Wilson. Wickline up high in the slot with it. Lost it out to center. Frazio tried to bank it across the ice. It hit Aldworth. Aldworth feeding it over right side. Wickline looking for a little help on the delay here. Puts it up to the right point. Vanelli arriving at a long shot way over top of the Danbury cage. Greco stepping in left point, trying to hold it in. Wickline over to the right side. as the River Dragons now working on a change here in behind the play while Danbury in its own end. Stretch through center, tipped away by Storjahan. Greco stepping up on the right side, had it knocked back. LaBelle chasing into the River Dragon zone. LaBelle over to the right side. Greco curling back is King. LaBelle left side. Jammed along by Storjahan. Up the far side, it goes back out to center. LaBelle will dump it in. King on the right side waiting. Feeds to the high slot. Kelly cutting to his right wing. Kelly, a shot. And again, off the shoulder of Wilson. River Dragons just putting it right into that big orange jersey. Here's Storjahan attacking on the right wing. Over to Kelly. His wrist shot. Ripped it wide on the stick side. Gesso tipping it off the dasher out to center. Petrantonio revving it up through center, cutting right up the middle of the ice. Petrantonio in with the wrister, and a save made by Wilson. Now golfed up top, not out. Underwood a shot, and that one is gobbled up and held. Wilson busy, but again, staying square to these shots, making the saves and holding on. .228 into this third period, 1-0. Danbury in the lead. Heitzner in for the faceoff. Wins it back. Jemayev with a wrist shot. That's blocked. Jemayev over to the right side. Underwood chasing. Underwood golfing it into the corner. Jemayev after it. Here's Heitzner. Near side sweeps it around to the left point. Petrangelo, long shot in, and that one Wilson found through traffic. Made a save. Heitzner into the right side corner on it. Jemayev up with the puck. Looking up top. Feeds to Rogers through traffic. Couldn't get it through. Pinball's over Petrantonio, can't keep it in as it's sent down the ice. Rogers chasing, that'll be icing. Three minutes into the third period, 1-0 Danbury, but the River Dragons waking up a little bit here. Really kind of going after it here. Nice to see them pressuring Danbury, trying to make the best of it. Faceoff will be to the right of Wilson's goal. Boy, the River Dragons really need to keep it going right now if they can. Capitalize on this momentum. Frazier holds a draw into the point, a shot in. That is blockered into the netting and out of play by Wilson. River Dragons will take that. Danbury at least gets a change out of it, which they did not before the icing. Wickline, Krupp, Aldworth out there with Frazio and Vanelli. Wickline winning the draw back. Left point, here's Frazio. Through traffic, shot in front is deflected wide. Ends up on the far wall off the body of Vanelli. Bouncing in the slot, now it's cleared. Frazio after the rolling puck. Tried to get it off the glass, can't lift it out of the zone. Kept in by Danbury, centering feed, poked away by the stick of Colgan. Frazio up with it through center. His feet onto the left side. Here's Aldworth trying to wheel past his man. Cannot. Falenga turning it the other way. Chasing it to the left side is Lugo. Knocked away to the line. Not out, though. Kept in. Hattrick's a chance. Backhanded in front. That one is blocked. And now let's see if Columbus can rush this one up left side, but Aldworth lost the handle on it. That allows Danbury back on the left side. They'll bank one in off the blocker of Colgan and out of play. 3:56 into the third period, it remains 1-0 Danbury. And River Dragons fans, it's your last chance to pre-order your authentic Columbus River Dragons jersey to be delivered before the end of the regular season. Customize that jersey with any name and number and show everyone how much you love the River Dragons. Orders must be placed by February 5th to guarantee on-time delivery. Go to rdragonsmerch.com. There's a shot in over the shoulder of Colgan. Ends up in the far side corner. Danbury trying to go to work. With the puck free to LaBelle. LaBelle up the left side with it. He'll push to center. Dump it in. Glove down by Wilson. And he elects to hold. Thought about playing it aside for a moment there. McDonald was there. But then said, no, I'll just go ahead and take my face off. Which will come to the right side. LaBelle and Greco manning the points here for Storjahan, Kelly, and King up front. Storjahan able to move the draw to the near side. Kelly sends it deep. King in the corner. Storjahan, dot shot, shoulder saved by Wilson. Now Greco steps up with a booming hit as the puck cleared down the ice. LaBelle after it. Kelly lost it. And, oh, almost too many men there for Danbury. But back comes Storjahan. Storjahan right side. He's got Rumini outside. Poked it on the backhand, but that goes wide of the net. And now Kelly tying up with this man, kept into the point momentarily there. And now I think we're going to get both Gesso and Kelly. Both teams' leading scores go to the penalty box or no? And Kelly gets run into by Kuznetsov on his way back to the bench. I thought they were going to take both, but maybe not. Gesso is trying to not go into the box. The linesman is steering him towards it. And confusion seems to be the order of the day. Gesso slamming the door shut as he gets in. 4:49, time of the penalty. River Dragons on to the second Georgia power play of the night, where they are 0-1. It was a big moment in this hockey game. Jemayev to the left point. Petrantonio, wrist shot in, tip, and Heitzner couldn't find the handle. He ends up with the near side. Goes to the left point, Petrantonio. Petrantonio getting it over to Rogers. Rogers, Jemayev, right half wall. Down low, Heitzner. And Brett looking for Doe, and that one knocked away by the goal stick of Wilson. Here's Doe, left half wall, up top, Rogers. Rogers, right side, tees, shot, tipped to the way in, save made, Wilson. Rebound, Doe with Wilson down, puck in front, Heitzner, stop. Rogers, try to wrist her, blocked, near corner, Petrantonio. Petrantonio, cross ice, far dot, shot. Jemayev missed the net, looks at the sky. Puck is cleared off Rogers down the ice. Boy, the River Dragons had Wilson down, just could not get a shot away. Holding the call, by the way, against Gesso. The River Dragons push ahead. Left side, here's LaBelle. LaBelle shot in. That one finds the far corner. Rogers to the right point. He'll hold. Move it to the middle of the blue line. Let it go through traffic. Right pad, save Wilson. Rebound sent down. 44 seconds to go on the Georgia power play. Is Cole going to leave it there for King? Just past 6 minutes into this third period. Storjahan, right side, moving in over the line. Lost it, but Kelly there to help him out. Kelly, Storjahan, top of the far circle. Going to get down low to King. Kelly, his shot, blocked. Chance around the rim. Will that get out? Yes, down it goes. Dowler put everything he had into it. Colgan sending the puck up to center. Kelly feeding left side of your Storjahan. 8 seconds to go on the power play. Wheeling it over the line. Storjahan with Kelly. Storjahan up top. LaBelle off his skates holding. Storjahan bottom of the circle. Off angle chance. And that one is somehow deflected out of play. Oh, the River Dragon so close but could not score on the Georgia power play. 6:52 gone in the third. It remains 1-0. Danbury in the lead. We are back with more River Dragons hockey.
IGH Properties specializes in managing single-family homes, single condos, entire HOAs, small and large apartments, and commercial business properties in the Chattahoochee Valley and beyond. Their expert property management team takes on the day-to-day chores of managing your rental property so you can enjoy a successful investment. Some of the responsibilities they handle are marketing, tenant interactions, lease agreements, and more. See them at IGHproperties.net. That's IGHproperties.net. IGH Properties. Happy tenants, happy owners, better rental.
So you've got projects to do around your home. You got Harvey Lumber for that. You've decided to finally get that large deck built in the back for family fun and entertaining like you've been dreaming about for so long. You got Harvey Lumber for that. From replacing a few boards to replacing all the windows to building from the ground up, you've got Harvey Lumber for that. It's kind of like that old saying, there's an app for that. Well, whatever you need in the way of building supplies, there's been a Harvey Lumber for that in the Chattahoochee Valley for over 150 years. Harvey Lumber Company, 815th Street, open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5.
Tom Callahan broadcasting live from the Harvey Lumber Press Box here atop Danbury Arena. River Dragons still trailing the Hattricks 1-0. Power play chance goes by the boards. They're 0 for 2, but boy, did they have their chances. Just could not convert. And so now Danbury back to 5-on-5, 7 minutes into this third period. Icing. Wow, that's a late, late icing call. Honestly, I thought they had waved it off by that point. But they do not, so the faceoff will come back down to the right of Brian Wilson. Faceoff will be to his right. Wick Lyon looking behind him. White referee is still at the bench saying, drop the puck, drop the puck. McDonald after it into the corner, chipped up the glass, left point, unable to hold it in. Frazio now away with it. Here comes Danbury. Lugo in with a shot, deflected away by Vanelli into the corner. Bouncing puck towards the line, ends up with Vanelli, but he can't get it out. Left side, Falenga throwing it towards the front. That one blocked again. Now back come Columbus. Here's Aldworth trying to use the speed on the left wing. Stops, cuts, slot, shot, score! Aldworth able to leak one through Wilson's pads! And the River Dragons tie at 7:36 into the third period. Aldworth stopped hard at the top of the near side circle and let go a wrist shot. May have used the defender as a screen a little bit. And Wilson got a piece of it, but not enough. Aldworth's 12th goal of the year. And the River Dragons have knotted this game up at one. Boy, does that change the complexion. Now Danbury is going to push back. Here's DeBenedet on the left side trying to walk in. Colgan will play it away. Petrantonio leaving for Jemayev. And now a collision in behind the play. Jemayev up 2-on-2 with Underwood right side. But Underwood lost it. It's played out to center. Petrantonio involved in a collision back, as I said, in the River Dragon zone. And he's a little slow to move anywhere. Petrantonio got run into over there. Looks like he's all right. Puck at the right point. Danbury able to hold it in. Petrantonio golfing it around the far side, does get it out to center. And now the puck turned back in. Now we get a whistle, and Rogers gets a stick up with one of the hat tricks. And now Heitzner goes over to do a little shoving. .822 gone here in the third, and the game tied up at one. I don't think we're going to get any penalties out of this. Honestly, we really shouldn't. It was just some pushing and shoving. Right now, Aldworth's goal is listed as unassisted. We'll see if that changes at all. But Aldworth has indeed tied this game up for the River Dragons here. As it's played around the glass, Greco at center tries to fire it back in. That one didn't get very far, and back the other way, here comes Danbury. On to the near side, however, it's Storjahan. He'll lead it ahead at center. King back for Greco, and now the puck turned over to Danbury. LaBelle chasing, that's an icing. Not quite 9 minutes into the third period. Faceoff will come back once again and the hat tricks end of things. And this is one of the things about the way Columbus plays this game. They just get better as the game wears on. And then at some point they get one, maybe two, maybe three. And then it just feels like the confidence zooms upward. And they're a different team. Here's Wick Lyon at center, turning with the puck, but he ran into an orange jersey. And so now River Dragons must regroup. Aldworth the other way. Now it'll be sent out to center. One turn in on goal. Colgan making the save. Right now, the hat trick's trying to go to work on the near side post. Colgan with a save there on the short side chance from Borshev. He will cover that one to get a whistle. 25 seconds shy of the halfway mark of period number three. Game tied at one. Faceoff coming on the dot to Colgan's left. One back towards Petrantonio. River Dragons have done a much better job on the draws here in the third period, that's for sure. Petrantonio will chip it in from center. Set right back up the far side wall. Jemayev into the right wing corner. Look for a little help with Underwood in the pile. Fed along to the right point. Rogers covers, stops. Feeds Jemayev from the right half wall. Into the high slot. Poked away Heintzner, but it ends up left point Petrantonio, and he just put it in the corner but hit the ref. How about the left side wall as Belenga can't clear. Jemayev turns back for it. Fell in the process. Sent to the near side. Gonzalez can't get it out either. Kept in by Underwood. Pamaleon finally able to get it out. And it's center Greco. Moved it ahead. Wanted Kelly, but led him too far. Back comes Danbury. But it chopped out of the air by Rogers. Heintzer steps back into the right side. He'll leave it up top. There's a chance to the wing. Looking for Storjahan, but that one is knocked away onto the glass. And now back the other way again. Here's the charge up the right side led by D. Benedict. In with a shot. Nice job by LaBelle to tip that wrister to the glass. LaBelle ends up with it in behind his own net. Coming up on 9 minutes to go in the third. This game is tied up at one. So Josh LaBelle, left side leader, Storjahan cutting in. Wanted to swing it in front for Kelly. Couldn't get it through to him. King into the corner, separates. Storjahan, left half wall with the puck, in a pile now. King helping him out on the wall. Storjahan sweeps it deep. Kelly behind the net, trying to free himself out the far side. Kelly to Storjahan on the cycle. Curls, quick shot, ripped it to the glass. Storjahan tried to find room on the top corner, but put it over the bar. Now Gesso moving it ahead. Kuznetsov, left wing, back to Gesso. His off-angle chance. Colgan way out to knock that away. And now heavy hit in the corner. Gesso dropped by Greco. Puck away to center. Kelly on it. Moving it ahead. LaBelle into the rush. Cuts in. Right pad. Save Wilson. Now Aldworth with a body at the left point. Keeps the puck alive. Bouncing in the slot. Kelly off his skates. Fights it through traffic. Tipped up in the air off a defender. And Wilson with a good save. He holds on. And when we come back, the faceoff will be in the Danbury zone, but these teams are starting to trade chances. Tied at one in the third, eight to go. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey. Hockey.
Is that the sound of an ooey gooey cheesy crunchy slice of P-I-Z-Z-A? Obviously. But as good as that sounds, we think it can get even better. Oh yeah, that's the sound of a freshly opened fizz-filled Pepsi. The only thing that can take this flavor medley of crunchy dough, mouth-watering cheese, and savory sauce to the next level. How about another bite? Pepsi and pizza sound like a match made in heaven and taste even better. Pizza, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
When the River Dragons have a breakdown, the puck can end up in the back of the net. But when your car has a breakdown, you need a reliable tow partner. Trust the tow company the River Dragons depend on, Tuffy's Towing. Tuffy's tows many types of vehicles in the Chattahoochee Valley. Call 706-457-0985 for a quote or go online to tuffystowing.com. Tuffy's, we tow more than just cars.
And we are back. Danbury Arena, the site of tonight's game and tomorrow night's game. 7 o'clock on the puck drop tomorrow night. Right now we're tied at 1, 8 minutes to go in the third period. River Dragons and the Hattricks. Here's Wickline on the near side. That puck is knocked away to center, but played ahead and ends up back with Krupp chasing all the way into his own end. He'll leave it off Vanelli to Frazio. Frazio banks it back for Vanelli. Lets it go up the right side. Krupp will curl back with it. Sends it to an open wing for Frazio. And now Here come the River Dragons. Aldworth to the line, not out, sent back in deep. On the left wing, it'll be fed behind the net. Danbury trying to center, right in front it goes, but unable to connect with that one was Marchesson. Right now, the River Dragons having a hard time getting it out of the zone. Wickline gets run into by Marchesson, but now the lead ahead. Here's Aldworth, but he couldn't get it to Krupp. Turn back the other way, chased by Wickline. Wickline can't catch up on the left side, though, now. Heitzner does. Heitzner curling behind the net. Centering feed, Wickline. Shot stopped by Wilson, and he's got the puck and hangs on. Now Wickline shoving behind the net with Dowler. They're still talking with the linesman in between them. Heitzner, of course, enjoys getting his words in there as well. So now the River Dragons with an offensive zone draw. Heitzner out along with Underwood and Doe. Petrantonio and Rogers on the points. Face off to the right of Wilson. River Dragons control. Petrantonio back to Doe on the left side. Into the slot. Oh, the pass is into the skates of Underwood. And it's slapped away from him. Danbury away to center. They'll try to bring it ahead. Here's Lugo. In with a chance. That one never got towards the net. Columbus ahead quickly, but the pass a little too far for Doe. Turned right back the other way. And now it ends up coughed up to Underwood. Pass at Petrantonio. Heitzner, Petrantonio wanted to put it back in front. That pass was blocked to the far side by Pamaleon. And now Doe into the high slot. Heitzner turnaround chance, that one off a shin pad. Puck stays in the slot. Underwood hooked it wide. Cleared off the glass, bounced to the line, out. Off of Rogers. Underwood getting back defensively here. Rogers cutting back. Nice job using his speed to get back and take that one away. 6:05 to go into third. This game's tied at one. Here comes Columbus, led by Kelly on the right wing. Fakes a shot, tried to tip it between the D. Did get in for a chance. Wilson had to be sharp to make that save, but he folds the body down on it and holds. 5:54 to go into third. Well, these teams have gone past regulation already once in the two games they played before. Danbury claimed that game in a shootout. Wonder if we might see some extra hockey here tonight, but there's still a decent amount of time up on that third period clock. This third period presented by IGH Properties. Fed to the right point, a bouncer, clear pass, Greco, two on one, Gesso, left side, trying to move it in front, nice job by LaBelle to block the pass. Now back the other way, here's Greco leading the charge to his left. Greco in over the line with a wrist shot, tipped into the near corner. Greco after his own rebound. Tying his man up on the near side, is played past Kelly. Kuznetsov pushing it ahead. Right side, Gesso in over the line, waits. Tried to feed it across. That was blocked by Storjahan. Storjahan tried to hook it out of the zone, could not. Kept into an open wing. King is back there helping out defensively. He takes a look, feeds it over to the near side. LaBelle to center. LaBelle and over the Danbury line, floats it in on goal, and Wilson does what he has all game long, catches and holds. Up until this third period, that's been a good strategy for Brian Wilson. His centers have done their job and have really been dominating the faceoff circle. But in the third, it's a different story. The River Dragons have come out and done a much better job on faceoffs. And now it'll be Wickline in, looking to try to win this back. They chop at it. He does get it to Krupp. Left point, Frazier. Right side, here's Albert sneaking down the right side, but he has to curl away from the check. Gets it behind to Krupp. Around to the left half wall to Frazier. Frazier back into the corner to Krupp. Krupp had it hop over his stick. Wickline chopped away from him as well. Richards able to move it out to center. Now the attack up the left side. McKittrick. McKittrick spins, tries to move it in front. Ends up back with Richards. He puts it behind the net. Now bounces right in front, and that one is poked away by Colgan. Could have been a fortunate bounce there for McKittrick, but he just couldn't find it in time. Send it on the backhand by Aldworth. Krupp is knocked down. That's going to be a penalty against Danbury. Interference will be the call. against Dowler. And when we come back with 4:25 to go into third, the River Dragons to the Georgia Power Power Play. We are tied at one, and this is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
IGH Properties specializes in managing single-family homes, single condos, entire HOAs, small and large apartments, and commercial business properties in the Chattahoochee Valley and beyond. Their expert property management team takes on the day-to-day chores of managing your rental property so you can enjoy a successful investment. Some of the responsibilities they handle are marketing, tenant interactions, lease agreements, and more. See them at IGHproperties.net. That's IGHproperties.net. IGH Properties. Happy tenants, happy owners, better rentals.
Craving a burrito, some nachos, or maybe even a quesadilla? Head to Bar Burritos. Their menu includes only the freshest ingredients, and your order is custom made how you want it on the spot. Bar Burritos is founded on freshness, and everything from our handmade guacamole to our marinades are made right in-house. And don't forget, you can order online at barburritos.com or through our handy mobile app. Bar Burritos. Food, community, people.
Back at Danbury Arena, Tom Callahan here with you. Face off to the right of that Danbury cage. River Dragons onto the third Georgia Power power play of the night. They're 0-2. Game is tied up at 1. And we now have 4:15 to go. And the puck cleared down the ice. That'll be chased by Kelly. Colgan will come out to field it. Kelly up onto the left side. Storjahan. On the wing, swings it around the dasher. Right side, King holding it in. Back behind the net, Storjahan had it played away to the line and unable to keep it in was LaBelle. Caught a little bit of an edge there, unfortunately. Kelly back to the right side, King. Storjahan in over the line, scoops it to the left wing corner. Kelly on it. Kelly, trouble with the bouncer, but got to the left point to LaBelle. LaBelle looking over to the far side, leaves it near side dot. Kelly, King in the near corner. King up top to LaBelle. LaBelle back to King. Pinballs Kelly. Feeds it. Right point Storjahan has to chase. Left point LaBelle. Backdoor feed. Looking for Kelly. Was tipped on the way through by Lugo. Lugo on a rolling puck trying to tie it up. Kelly looking to steal it back. River Dragons pursuing over there. Greco into that pile to pin a man on the wall. King trying to pull it out of the skates. He does. He'll rim it around. Left point waiting is LaBelle. LaBelle. Right back down the wall into the corner as he gets cleaned out at the left point. Puck tied up in the corner again. And now a centering feed. Lugo looked like he took a stick up high. No call coming, but back the other way. Jesso for a shorthanded chance. Now Storjahan took a stick up high. No call on that one. So, well, there you go. Turnabout is fair play. Heitzner, right side with 18 seconds of the power play. He'll fire it in from there. Wilson stays put. Left side, Jamea, leaving it for Doe. Doe looking in front. Centering feed blocked by Wilson and cleared out. 5 seconds to go and the man advantage. That'll do it for the River Dragons here. Tied at one. Under 2.5 to go into third. But moving it ahead is Rogers. Rogers cut off at the line. Got it into the near side corner. Cleared to an open wing. Petrantonio tried to step up. Could not get there first. Battles his way back for the puck. Turns it over, and now Heitzner in on the right side. He's got a chance, digging in Jamea. Heitzner, a shot, save Wilson, and he's able to grab the rebound. And he holds on. Boy, Heitzner was sniffing for that one with Jamea digging for the net. .205 to go into third. Tied it. Well, let's take a break. 10 seconds along the network. Station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2, Fort Benning South, Columbus, and W295AY, Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
1-1 with 2:05 to go here in period number three. River Dragons and the Hattricks have really battled here back and forth in this third period. That faceoff is sent down for an icing. No. Okay. Wow. So now Aldworth turning back with it. They'll leave it back off. And Vanelli moving it ahead. Quick line onto the right wing. His pass over the skates of Aldworth. And that's offside at the line. And this offside is brought to you by Old School Barbershop. Online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. If your sides are a little off, Check out Old School Barbershop, where you can book online anytime. You can also book online 24/7 through their Instagram and Facebook. 1:37 to go in the third. Tied at one. Faceoff will come just outside the Danbury blue line. Wickline, Doe, Heitzner out there. Aldworth tied it up here in the third. Can the River Dragons maybe push this one to a regulation win? They've got the momentum right now. Crashing on the right side is Aldworth. Puck glove down. Wickline centering feed. Looking for Doe. That one cleared onto the near side. And now Doe had his stick knocked away in the process. Puck is not out. And now it's cleared out. Spinorama effort there by DeBenedict. Got it out. Back into the right side, though, pushes Wickline. Doe after it. Sent away from him onto the near wing. And now cleared down the ice. Vanelli turning to race after it. And again, they wave off icing. Gesso hooks up Vanelli. Vanelli hooked him back and played the puck up the near wall. Aldworth pressured, left it at the line, couldn't clear the zone. Aldworth looks extremely tired out there. Right now, Danbury trying to push back in at the line. Gesso, who also looks tired out there, couldn't work his way through two white jerseys. Chip to the line, not out. Danbury holding in. Over to the right side, Gesso with it. Feeds it back over the left point. There's a long shot coming in, hit a body in front, and now back the other way. Here's Doe with the lead ahead. And now trying to race free is Kelly. Kelly still following the play. Puck is tied up. And now cleared back, Kuznetsov. He'll bring it ahead. Kuznetsov, left wing side, cutting wide 18 seconds ago. A shot that goes right across the goal mouth. Puck from the right point, nowhere near the net. And now King will clear it down. Looking for Kelly, but he couldn't catch up with the lead. 7 seconds to go. Dumped in on Colgan. He'll play it aside, leave it there for LaBelle. And guess what? We are going to overtime. So the River Dragons and the hat tricks. Well, just can't figure it out in regulation time. So we're going to need a little bit of extra hockey here. So it will be 3-on-3 for a maximum of 5 minutes. If we do not get a goal in that period, we go to a shootout, which is best of three, and then round by round. And the River Dragons this season, couple of overtime wins. Most recently, Carolina, 6-5 overtime win on the 21st of January. Now, they have gone past regulation with Danbury before. That was on December 2nd, and that turned into a 4-3 shootout loss for the River Dragons. The River Dragons also won in overtime on December 17th against Elmira. See if we can get an update on those third period stats for you here as we turn that corner. Well, how about this shot differential in the third period? 15-4 in favor of the River Dragons, who now end up out shooting Danbury for the game 33-27 as we move into overtime. So it looks like that pendulum of momentum has clearly swung back to the River Dragons side of things. So let's hope they can keep that going their way, although Danbury did wake up a bit at the end of regulation. The scoring in this one, 5:37 of the second, it was Marchesson, his 16th, but then Aldworth at 7:36 of the third found a way to squeak one through the pads on Wilson. And so now 3-on-3 overtime is ready to go. Kelly, Storjahan, and LaBelle out. Storjahan wins the draw back to LaBelle. Columbus will possess, and LaBelle will retreat all the way behind his own net and start it out. Pass ahead, turned over by LaBelle. Here's a chance in with a shot, put up over top of the net. Boy, McKittrick picked that one off right at center. Now poked the headers, LaBelle into the race for the puck. Back the other way, Danbury. Now Storjahan turns it over. Storjahan right side, LaBelle crashing the net. Storjahan right side in, stops Kelly in the slot, a shot, tipped just wide. LaBelle on the puck, feeds it around behind the net, but no one over there for the River Dragons. They're going to start a change here as Aldworth steps out along with Greco. Kelly stays up front on the forecheck. And he will head to the bench as soon as he gets a chance, I'm sure. Here's Danbury moving up. In over the line, right side. Wickline hops out there for Kelly. Greco and Gesso just jousting at each other in behind the play. I just don't think you're going to see a call here in the overtime unless it is just blatant. And by that, I mean either the removal of an appendage or a denial of a scoring chance. Greco will move it ahead. Aldworth wheeling his way through center, weaves to the left side. He'll come in on the line, stop. Now try to restart into the corner. Got tied up over there. Has his stick held, trying to kick it free. Wickline on the near side. Can't control it. DeBenedict getting it across. Now DeBenedict crashing to the net. There's a chance coming in on the backhand. DeBenedict stopped by the right pad of Colgan. What a save by Brendan Colgan. Absolutely preserving the tie. Heitzner moving back with King as they weave in. Here's King on the right side. In. King behind the net. Wraps it around. Tried to feed to the left point, but didn't have a lot on it. Vanelli sending it right back down the rim. Heitzner after Gesso in the corner. Who skates by King as well. And now Gesso pushing ahead. In on the right side. Long shot. Save Colgan with the blocker. We played 2:15 of this three-on-three overtime. Tied at one. River Dragons and the hat tricks. Heitzner in, wheeling, left side, leaves it for Austin Doe. Doe walks his way in, a shot, and the save made by Wilson, who holds on. Doe got it around the D, but was in so tight to the goaltender, he tried to flip it up over him, but couldn't find daylight. .231 of this potentially five-minute max overtime. Tied at one. Jemayev in for this faceoff, but it's won back by Danbury, and the hat tricks with possession here. Wheeling his way ahead is Marchesson. He's got the goal for Danbury and offside at the line. This offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop, online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. Need a little off your sides? Check out Old School Barbershop, where you can book online anytime. Doe out there, Jemayev and Rogers. Here in the OT, Jemayev winning it over. Now Rogers will step ahead and 2-on-1. Rogers right side in with Doe. Rogers, a shot. Save made. Wilson rebound. They score. The River Dragons manage to punch the puck up in the air, and it goes in just over the head of Wilson. It dings in off the underside of the crossbar. A dramatic overtime winner. 2:54 into the extra session. And Columbus, a big-time win on the road. What a victory for the River Dragons. Unbelievable. And so, Columbus will head off the ice. And, wow, what a win. What a win. There's still some talking out on the ice, of course, as you would expect after a finish like that. But the River Dragons win it 2:54 into the overtime. I think it's going to be Doe getting credit for the goal, but it could be Rogers. How about we tell you about it when we come back? We got the Wade Cleaners 3-star of the game coming your way, as well as a Pepsi post-game show. That's on the other side of the break. And, wow, what a win for the River Dragons in the OT. 2-1 your final. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled to perfection burger sounds amazing, yeah, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang. Burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-thru and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
It's time for the Pepsi Postgame Show on the River Dragons Broadcast Network. Tonight's show is brought to you by Pepsi, Air Force Heating and Air, Beam TV, Zelmo Zip-In, and Wade Cleaners. Now, with a recap of tonight's action, here's Tom Callahan.
So we are back here at Danbury Arena, where the Columbus River Dragons victorious tonight in overtime, and the goal does indeed go to Cody Rogers, his seventh of the year, from Austin Doe and Alexander Jabeyev, 2:54 of the overtime. Big, big win for the River Dragons here over the Danbury Hattricks. Took them a little OT, but they'll take it for their 27th victory of the year. So our three stars of the game are brought to you by Wade Cleaners. Wade Cleaners, the official cleaners of Torch and Scorch, is chosen by the media here in Danbury tonight. Third place goes to the goaltender for the Danbury Hattricks, Brian Wilson. Wilson finishing up the game this evening, 33 saves on 35 shots. Second star goes to Brendan Colgan, who I thought was outstanding this evening. 28 of 29 for Colgan and picking up his 14th win of the season. And the first star goes to the guy with the game-winning goal, Cody Rogers, his seventh of the year. Let's take a break. We'll come back, and we've got that Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard coming your way, plus a look back at the scoring and this one. Stick around. More to come. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. It's hockey.
You know that sound anywhere. It's the crisp crunch of that first nacho chip. With its perfect cheese to sour cream ratio sitting atop a layer of delicious beans, it's a sip away from perfection. That's what we're looking for. Add a delicious, refreshing Pepsi, and we've achieved absolute nacho nirvana. Because while you can pile those nachos high with every spicy, cheesy, savory topping, there's no topping a cool Pepsi finish. Nachos, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-thru and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
Complete Tire and Service, located at 3109 Victory Drive in Columbus, is the perfect place to take care of everything your vehicle needs. From preventive maintenance to alignments, brakes, oil changes, and more, your friends at Complete Tire and Service have you covered. Need tires? Buy three, get one free for passenger vehicles. Call 706-321-8133 to set up your appointment. 321-8133. Complete Tire and Service on the web at ctstires.com. In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We are proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
We'll be right back.
Back here at Danbury Arena, Tom Callahan here with you in the Pepsi post-game show. As we take a look at the scoring here to wrap things up for you, the River Dragons with a 2-1 win here in overtime over the Danbury Hattricks. No scoring in that first period where shots were 11-9 in favor of Danbury. And again, the theme throughout this game for Columbus is going to be Brendan Colgan playing fantastic. He made several big saves in each period. But then, as I talk about, they bend, they don't break, they get better as the game goes along. Tonight, they're able to claim the victory in overtime. So no scoring in the first period. In the second period, the breakthrough comes at 5:37 as a puck in front by Michael Marchessault really meant more of a cross-ice pass, but it deflects in off Paul Fraggio. For the 16th of the year for Marchessault, Richards the assist at 5:37, and it's 1-0 Danbury. That's the way it would stay through 40 minutes of play, and into the third we go, where the River Dragons probably starting to generate some of their best chances of the hockey game. They did well at the end of the second period, had a couple good shifts. Into the third, the River Dragons finally able to break through at 7:36. Thomas Aldworth, his 12th, a shot from the top of the near circle as Aldworth attacked with speed, then stopped. The defender may have turned into a screen there, but Aldworth's wrist shot leaks through the goaltender, Brian Wilson. Krupanwyk line the assist at 7:36, and the game is tied up at 1, where we would end regulation. And then move it on into overtime, where at 2:54, it's Cody Rogers, following his rebound to the net, scores his 7th of the year from Doe and Jemayev. 2-1 your final, River Dragons win it. Shots by period, Columbus 9 in the first, 9 in the second, 15 in the third, 2 in the overtime for 35. Danbury 11-12, just 4 in the third period, 2 in the overtime for Danbury. They finish with 29 shots. So 2-1 your final here, and the power plays, by the way, in this one 0 for 2 for Danbury, 0 for 3 for the River Dragons. And a tightly contested game, a difficult game for both of these teams. But at the end of the day, both goaltenders played excellent. But the River Dragons just found that way to get that one more as Rogers able to jam at that rebound. It pops up over the head of the goaltender. Wilson glances in under the crossbar. And the River Dragons skate off with the victory. Come on back and join us here in the Pepsi postgame show. Up next, we've got our Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard, and then we wrap things up here from Danbury, Connecticut, where the River Dragons win it in overtime. 2-1 your final. We're back with more in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain is your trusted plumber in Columbus and beyond. We go the extra mile to show up on time, diagnose your situation quickly, and get to the root of the problem. Blue Frog is here to deliver the right solution the first time. And we're available 24/7 because plumbing emergencies don't keep office hours. Blue Frog Plumbing and Drain. Less mess, less stress. On the web at bluefrogplumbing.com or call 706-887-6433.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in 4 different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
Hydrolife Therapy at Old Town is your one-stop recovery shop to get you back to 100%. With IV therapy treatments, cryotherapy, and compression therapy all under one roof, Hydrolife treatments are packed with nutrients to increase energy and boost your immune system. Join the IV League today for the most affordable way to feel better, look better, and start accomplishing more. Online at hydrolifetherapy.com/Columbus. Hydrolife Therapy. Start living your best life.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon fiberglass and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Back here at Danbury Arena for the wrap-up here in the Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. Tom Callahan here with you from the Harvey Lumber Press Box. No NHL scores tonight because it's skills competition evening in the National Hockey League. However, we got scores aplenty in the FPHL. Binghamton with a big 8-2 win over Delaware here tonight. Meanwhile, you've got Motor City 4-3 winners over Elmira on the road. And then you have Carolina right now trying to hang on late against Watertown. They've got a 4-3 lead with just over a minute to go in that game. Thunderbirds trying to secure the victory in that one. We're back at it again tomorrow night right here with Danbury, 7 o'clock on the puck drop slated for that one, 6:30 on our pregame show. And once again, the River Dragons winning a 2-1 in overtime. Here tonight, Rogers, the game winner, 2:54 into the extra session from Jemayev and Austin Doe. And Columbus, big, big overtime victory. And now the season series pretty much sealed up for the River Dragons here. They are now 2-0-1, and the final game coming tomorrow night. So, Danbury, this is another important thing to talk about. Danbury, if there is a head-to-head tiebreak, again, like I said, if these two teams should happen to meet in the final for whatever reason, and, you know, they're two of the best teams in the league, that could also be a big one. So regulation wins, Columbus has the edge. Head-to-head, Columbus will win the season series. All very important. And right now, the River Dragons certainly would like to close things out tomorrow night with a victory. I have to say thanks to Drew Pierce for standing next to me and freezing just like I am here at Danbury Arena. It is cold up here, but that's all right. We won. Hey, Columbus comes out with the victory. We will talk to you tomorrow night, folks. Thank you so much. That'll do it for your Pepsi postgame show. Drew and I are back at it again tomorrow night, 6:30. Pregame, 7 o'clock. Puck drop. We'll talk to you then. Thanks for tuning us in, everybody. You've been listening to Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
To the Pepsi postgame show on the River Dragons Broadcast Network. Tonight's show was brought to you by Pepsi, Air Force Heating and Air, Beam TV, Zelmo Zip-In, and Wade Cleaners. All rights to this broadcast are reserved by the Columbus River Dragons and PMB Broadcasting for the private use of their audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, or other distribution or the descriptions or accounts of this game are expressly prohibited without the written consent of Ignite Sports and Entertainment and PMB Broadcasting. This has been a presentation of the Columbus River Dragons Hockey Club.